designed to dupe consumers into spending far more money than they had. Investigators believe the fraudulent corporation also lured victims in with enticing rewards programs and free gifts, thereby trapping them in a spiral of debt they could never hope to repay. According to the results of a groundbreaking new study, 96% of humans would rather be a singing, dancing animatronic bear. The study finds that a great majority of people on the planet would prefer to trade in their regular lives for one in which they sat on a plastic log, strummed a banjo, and sang songs on a stage with all their goofy bear friends. Respondents also stated that not being a sentient human being with feelings of doubt, sadness, and pain contributed to the decision.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything that you want. All you have to do is dial in toll-free here. It is the live Saturday edition. The number brought to you by ProXPN is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, Ian here.
And Mark.
As we always do here on Free Talk Live, we will take your calls about anything. You can reach us on those toll-free lines. You can also reach us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out in that way if you have that as an option. Lots of stuff to talk about on the table here tonight, but news out of Colorado, which is interesting. A lot of people, of course, are afraid about the idea of cannabis being legalized there. It happened in 2012 during a vote. It was a referendum. It took them a little while to kind of implement things, and in early 2014, the beginning of this year, January, Colorado became the first state to actually have legal cannabis, wherein you could go to a store, a cannabis dispensary of some sort, and you, as an adult, can purchase cannabis legally, walk out, and be totally fine. Now, there may still be a law in Denver, for instance, about smoking it in public. I believe that's still the case. But at the very least, it's legal to purchase it and transport it to your own home, or to a piece of private property wherein you can consume it legally, which is very exciting. It's very good news. It's great news because it ends a good chunk of the war on drugs in Colorado, which is, I think, an exciting thing. It means that fewer people will be put in jail cells and have their lives ruined for being arrested for cannabis. And if you don't think that happens, you just don't know many people in the, kind of the counterculture, the drug culture. But there's a lot of fear that comes around with this. And, we've seen the headlines about a small child finds a marijuana cookie and eats the cookie and gets sick, or somebody got a brownie from somewhere and they didn't realize there was marijuana or cannabis baked into the brownie and they ate too much and they got sick. So these stories do exist. There's no reason to doubt their veracity, I don't think. But that's one of the kind of the scares.
Sure, but I mean, let's think about those alcoholic beverages that are bright colors out
there. Yeah, sure. Very pretty, very attractive to children.
I'm sure that you're not hearing...
Sweet.
Yeah, you're not... Yeah, they are sweet, and they taste just fine.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure we never hear the stories about the kid that drank the Bartles and James...
Great point. And puked.
And, puked or may have...
Blacked out.
Alcohol kills people.
That's true as well. And how often does alcohol causing problems make the front page of the newspaper? Not very often.
It's just poison control at that point.
Right, unless it's a drastic accident, which, caused tragic loss of life. Odds are good that somebody getting too wasted on alcohol and being stupid, doing something they'll regret, or perhaps losing control of their physical faculties, that's so common, it's not news. Right. I mean, right. It's Saturday night. We're on the air across the United States. Odds are good a fair amount of our audience has some kind of an alcoholic beverage in their hand. And as the night goes on, that amount, the percentage of that happening, it likely increases. So, yeah, that's a great point, Mark. So, yeah, OK, drugs, cannabis is legal in Colorado. So inevitably, that means that there may be more of it in cookie or a brownie form, some sort of edible form. They've got the cannabis candy
now. But what they're not saying, what doesn't ever hit the news, because these pot brownie things or pot candy bars or whatever, they hit the news and they hit it pretty hard.
Mm-hmm.
What you don't hear is out of the Washington Post, since marijuana legalization, highway fatalities in Colorado are at a near historic low.
Now, is that a correlative sort of thing, or is it just one of those interesting figures? There's no way to really say that, right?
No, there's... I don't know. I mean...
It's interesting.
When you can say... When you can go to California, you can say that youth crime is down mm-hmm. since marijuana's near legalization in California, and you can say that automobile accidents are a near historic low in Colorado. I mean, yeah, there. How do you find out how an automobile accident was caused?
Well, I mean, you can certainly, if the person's alive, they could be tested for substances.
Well, but this is a lack of accidents,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, that's a good point.
How do you figure out what a lack of accidents is caused by?
Right, right. Good point.
Well, the stoners are staying home, I guess. I mean, I don't know.
Or maybe more. It'd be interesting to look at alcohol sales, too. What about alcohol sales? Have alcohol sales gone up, down, or stayed relatively the same after cannabis has been legalized? Because you could theorize that, you know, maybe somebody, if they can purchase cannabis legally, would be more likely to purchase cannabis than perhaps drink alcohol. I mean, I have known people
who... I can tell you that alcohol manufacturers have always historically been against marijuana legalization.
They have lobbied, actually. They've paid alcohol manufacturers, I believe, are some of the members of the so-called Partnership for a Drug-Free America, which is, of course, an ironic thing because alcohol's the most powerful, probably tied with heroin for the most powerful and destructive drug out there. And it's, you know, mostly legal. So here's the news, actually. This is pretty interesting news from Reason.com, their hit-and-run blog. New survey data from Colorado indicate that marijuana legalization, so far, has not led to an increase in pot smoking by teenagers, as prohibitionists warned that it would. In the 2013 Healthy Kids Colorado survey, 37% of high school students reported that they had ever tried marijuana, down from 39% in 2011. The percentage who reported using marijuana in the previous month also declined from 22% in 2011 to 20% in 2013. Now, is it really fair to look at 2013 numbers here in this study? I guess it was. Was it legal in 2013? I don't think it was. I think it was. Like, was it legal to possess it after the. After the voters passed this in 2012? In 2013, did it become legal to just kind of have pot? Well, and then in 2014, it became legal to buy the pot?
I think they just kind of ramped down arrests. I mean, it's got to be very, demoralizing for a police officer to when the vote's, been had but has not been implemented.
The percentage who reported using marijuana in the previous month also went down from 22% to 20%. The State Department, Public Health and Environment, which oversees the survey, says these decreases are not statistically significant, but they are part of a general downward trend in Colorado that has continued despite the legalization of medical marijuana in 2001, the commercialization of medical marijuana in 2009, and the legalization of recreational use along with home cultivation and sharing among adults at the end of 2012. The earlier numbers come from the CDC's Youth Risk Behavior Survey, to which Colorado contributes data from its own survey. Their survey is conducted every other year from the CDC, and Colorado has not always participated. Still, this doesn't look what you would expect to look like what you'd expect to see if relaxing restrictions on marijuana led to more underage consumption. In fact, the downward trend during this period is clearer in Colorado than in the country as a whole. So if you go back all the way to 1999, there's a marijuana use by American teenagers, and I believe this is of all America. It's not... Yeah, okay. So I'm looking at marijuana use by Colorado teenagers. In 1997, it was 46% had said that they had used marijuana. Medical marijuana was legalized in 2001, and it began going on a downward trend. It actually has been going on a downward trend, but as marijuana was legalized for medicinal purposes, as it was commercialized for medicinal purposes, meaning that it could then be available through dispensaries, through medical marijuana dispensaries, this whole time, Colorado has had a downward trend in teenagers using marijuana. So,
well, this is the one thing that is baffling to people who are sort of against these marijuana legalization things. And I frankly, it baffles me too. I really don't understand. But
why? It says this doesn't confuse me. You take away the forbidden fruit aspect, it doesn't become as sexy. It's not, it doesn't have the sizzle.
I smoked cigarettes in high school.
And you weren't allowed to.
Well, I guess that they were, but they were legal. Marijuana's not legal for
people. But it wasn't legal for you to smoke cigarettes.
Is it legal for high school students to smoke marijuana in Colorado?
No, I guess it wouldn't be.
I don't understand. But the fact is that you cannot it is undeniable when you look at Portugal, when you look at Amsterdam, you look at these places that have decriminalized drugs, specifically marijuana, and you see a decrease in use. That it's really difficult to look at the U.S. when all these drugs were legal fewer than 100 years ago. It's difficult to look at those numbers, but the evidence is that the percentage of the population that uses them has either stayed the same or gone up.
The toll-free number...
The war on drugs has not diminished use.
...is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It almost seems like the best way to reduce drug use is to legalize them.
Those are the numbers.
That's what happened in Amsterdam, and now it's happening in Colorado, and it can happen in your state if you actually do this and you legalize pot and other drugs too. 855-450-FREE.
In a far future universe, Earth's fleet is shattered, rife with guerrilla warfare, interspecies diplomacy, and full-scale interstellar combat. Humanity is about to face its trial by fire. Trial by Fire, Book 2 in the Tales of the Terran Republic, sequel to the national best-selling and award-winning Fire with Fire by distinguished professor and author Charles Gannon. Get it now from Amazon through shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. It's the live Saturday edition of the program. We invite you to take control of the airwaves here. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features on the site there. Lots of stuff. You get to create the content you submit right there to the front page. Others who listen can vote on voting up or down on things they like or dislike, and you get to vote on things as well. Just go to freetalklive.com. All you need is a free Reddit account and a free Free Talk Live account. You link the two together in a very quick process and makes it easy for you to get interactive with us at freetalklive.com. And we accept Bitcoin. The important question is, you've got Dell.com, you've got Wikipedia now, you've got all kinds of online businesses, and even real-life businesses now are accepting Bitcoin. The important question is, are you accepting Bitcoin? Well, if you want to get started, you've got to get a Bitcoin wallet, and you can do that by going to blockchain.com and grabbing the free blockchain wallet. Makes it really easy to accept and send out Bitcoin, especially if you have a smartphone. If you've got a smartphone, this is like a must-do. Blockchain.com. Go and grab your free Bitcoin wallet. We were talking about cannabis legalization out in Colorado and how apparently the statistics are showing that teenagers' use of cannabis, despite the fact that Colorado in 2001 legalized medical marijuana and then in 2009 commercialized medical marijuana, meaning you could go to dispensaries and acquire it easily. And then, of course, in 2014, or actually, I guess, voted in 2012 to legalize cannabis, which was implemented earlier this year. Year after year after year, teenagers using cannabis, the numbers are dropping. And statistically, over time, quite a bit, actually. So the old argument from the prohibitionists, the people who want to keep the status quo, who want to keep arresting pot smokers, their argument for continuing prohibition, one of the strongest sounding arguments, at least, is that the claim that, oh, well, if you legalize it, then the teenagers are just going to start using even more marijuana than before. But there's no evidence for that whatsoever. Not in Amsterdam, where they've been experimenting with marijuana decriminalization for what, 2 decades now? It seems like it's been quite a while.
Yeah.
So it hasn't happened there. And now, of course, you could always claim then, well, that's apples and oranges. You can't compare Amsterdam with the United States. United States teenagers are much worse and they're more likely to smoke pot. So, you know, you can make that up. You can say apples and oranges, not fair to compare. Well, now we don't. Now it's no more apples and oranges. Now it's Colorado, right here in the United States. The numbers are pretty firm and pretty clear.
And
teenage use does not go up. In fact, in point of fact, it's actually going down in Colorado.
Well, we can also see that crime has diminished in California, correlative to marijuana being basically decriminalized there for, at the very least, medical purposes. But it's very easy to get a medical card in California. We can see here in this story that in Colorado, that since marijuana legalizations, highway fatalities are a near historic low. So I don't know if people are driving more carefully or just not getting on the road. They're staying in their living room and having a trip right there.
Well, the evidence shows that stone drivers are safe, as safe as, if not safer than, regular drivers. They're more cautious on the roads. Let's go to Mike in Maryland. You're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, hi. Yeah, thanks for taking my call. Yeah, this is a really fascinating subject. And to me, there's a lot of questions with the whole marijuana situation in Colorado. But correct me if I'm wrong, didn't Washington State legalize marijuana as well, or am I mistaken?
They did legalize with a referendum in 2012, but I think the implementation of it, I think, has dragged out a little bit. Maybe it just started this summer.
They don't have the businesses in Washington that are going in like they are in Colorado.
Yeah, there's some sort of delay that's happening there, and I don't know what it is. Maybe somebody in Washington State can give us an update on that. But yes, in Seattle, we did see some numbers earlier this year. Statewide, actually, the numbers of arrests have just dropped off the map. The only people they're arresting now is big, you know, dealers or whatever, or at the very least people with ounces and ounces of pot or over an
ounce.
People
moving bales.
So literally the arrests went from like 7,000 a year down to 70 or something like that.
Okay, well, see, I have some questions, and one of them is, now, if I understand it correctly, if you go into a pot dealer, you know, I don't want to say dealer.
Store.
Dispensary?
You know, dispensary, whatever. You can only buy a quarter ounce at a time. Is that right?
Are you talking about in Colorado?
In Colorado, yeah.
I haven't heard that that is true. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me, but at the same time, I believe you can possess up to an ounce. So I would also guess you could probably buy up to an ounce.
Okay, and do they have, like, different grades?
Oh, my, yes, they do.
Types?
Oh, yes, they certainly do. In fact, the main two types of cannabis are indica and sativa. Those are the types of, is it the genus? Is that the word for the plants? Anyway, there's two kinds
of species.
Species, if you will, of cannabis plants, and those are the two main ones. I think there's also cannabis ruralis as well, but nobody ever talks about that for some reason. But yeah, so indica and sativa, and then of course, within those two areas, there are so many different types. I mean, there's all kinds of names out there. Bubblegum, blueberry, AK-47. There's just all kinds of different strains. These strains, of course, have been cultivated for many years. It's not like they just were created out of nowhere in Colorado. The seeds have been available. That's why Mark Emery from Canada went to prison for so many years, because he sold those seeds on the internet to anybody who wanted to buy them. So yes, the answer is there are all kinds of different strains, and the people who use them, especially for medical purposes, many of them swear by very specific strains. They get different results from different strains of marijuana with their medical conditions that they have. And so they experiment with different types and find what works best for them to provide them the relief that they need. And even the people who are using them for recreational purposes, some prefer the high that they receive from a sativa plant versus an indica plant, or vice versa. So the answer is yes, there's quite the variety.
Okay, well, I was curious. I wonder how the state-sponsored marijuana sales, you know, the price compares to how it used to be when you buy it on the street.
Another good question.
I was wondering about that, and I guess is it still illegal for somebody to ship pot into Colorado and sell it on the street, or to grow their own and sell it?
Shipping it across state lines would likely be a federal crime. That would be my guess. I'm not an attorney. This isn't legal advice, but that would likely be a federal issue at that point. So yes, that would probably still be considered illegal. And to your question about how much it costs, the last time we looked at this was probably about a month in to this whole experiment. So I don't know what's happened to the prices recently, but the last time we discussed it, basically the position was that because the demand was so ridiculously high out there, that
there's people coming in to Colorado
tourism,
to
sure.
smoke marijuana, and I think it's going to take a little while for the marketplace to kind of reach an equilibrium. But I think you're exactly right. When somebody can go out and grow a marijuana plant, which is a very easy thing to grow.
It's a weed. Yeah. Throw the seeds out in the backyard and you'll have marijuana plants.
And so when you can just toss seeds out in your backyard and then have marijuana plants, that's really going to put a lot of downward pressure on pricing, even for the high end bubblegum AK-47, whatever that stuff is.
Well, interestingly, so what they found was that the medical marijuana is cheaper than the regular marijuana, even though it's the same pot.
Okay. Can you grow it in your backyard as well?
As I understand it,
you can.
As I understand it, I'm not familiar with all the rules there. You can have, there's some level of home grow available, and I can't imagine they would restrict somebody to only growing inside. Hey, thanks, Mike, for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. And of course, to anybody that wants to really dig into the details on these issues, there's all kinds of documentation coming out of Colorado, which is great, because Colorado and Washington are going to be these experimental places that people can look to say, this whole ending prohibition thing, it's not such a bad idea after all. Free Talk Live.
If you need to say happy birthday, happy anniversary, thank you, or simply, I'm thinking of you, ProFlowers.com is the key. ProFlowers has stunning bouquets, like the best-selling 100 blooms for $19.99. Plus, ProFlowers will include a glass vase for free. Sending someone a wonderful surprise of beautiful flowers sent fresh from the field is easy. Choose the bouquet you like, pick the delivery date, and each order is 100% guaranteed. Plus, all bouquets from ProFlowers are guaranteed to last at least 7 full days. Beautiful, fragrant flowers, picked fresh and sent to your loved one for lasting enjoyment. To get this incredible savings and send someone 100 gorgeous blooms with a free vase for $19.99, go to ProFlowers.com. Click the blue microphone in the top right corner and enter code PLOW. That's ProFlowers.com. click the mic, and enter code PLOW.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Imagine for a moment a radio program, the most personal of mediums, that reaches hundreds of thousands of people on more than 140 radio stations across the U.S. and around the world through the internet with podcasts and live streams. Imagine the advertising is affordable from $600 to $6,000 a month. Free Talk Live is that program. We will work with you to get clicks, calls, views, or sales. Email me at mark@freetalklive.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything that you want right here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. I don't imagine anybody out there actually opposes the decriminalization or legalization of marijuana. At the very least,
yes, they do.
It's been so long since any of them have called into the show.
Well, the evidence is really dwindling. I mean, this took...
Right, what else do you have? The teenagers are not using pot in Colorado as much as they used to. They're down. The usage is down.
This took a lifetime. When I was on... when I was, you know, in my teenage years on MTV, you'd see this... This is your brain. This is your brain on drugs.
I learned it from watching you!
Right, all that Remember nonsense that, they talk about, which... You know, I mean, yeah, there certainly are things that affect your brain poorly, but among them, marijuana is the least of it, and it just always got lumped in with the other drugs. And so it's taken people a very long time, and it's amazing how just sort of slow and plodding people are, but now that Washington and Colorado are doing it, and people all over the country are like, yeah, oh, it's no big deal. Was it a big deal 10 years ago when you people were letting... people get thrown in jail for it.
By the way, just to answer our earlier caller's question again, or a little bit more detailed, he asked about the price of legal pot versus illegal pot. It is lower in Colorado to purchase. It's a lower price
Less
to
costly.
Purchase. Yeah, it's legal high-grade cannabis in Colorado is cheaper than buying it in the black market in general. Hey, if you need focus and are feeling fatigued and you're trying to get that extra edge when it counts, check out modafinil from modup.net. Studies show 1 in 5 students use this cognitive enhancer, offering multiple benefits, including a double-digit increase in short-term memory, fighting off fatigue, and greater focus overall, so you can get things done. Businessmen around the world are talking about modafinil from modup.net and how it's making the difference in their work and giving them the critical edge they need. Over at modup.net, they provide the highest premium quality modafinil with the best potency, so you enjoy significant results. That's why they're the number one sponsor of Reddit's third-party nootropic testing project. Now remember, Free Talk Live is an international radio show, and modup.net ships worldwide. It's your responsibility to know if local prescription requirements and laws apply. So go to modup.net and place your order. If you've got Bitcoin, you're going to pay with Bitcoin, you get a 33% discount. Plus, you can use code FTL to get 10 free tablets with your order. So don't forget code FTL at modup.net for modafinil. That's M-O-D-U-P, modup.net. Right back into your calls and thoughts. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You don't have to talk about ending cannabis prohibition and how all the claims from the prohibitionists, including their main claim that, what about the children? Well, it turns out young people in Colorado are using cannabis less than ever. Warren, you're on in Iowa, listening to Free Talk Live. Hey there.
Yeah, I just turned 60 a little while ago, and I was smoking pot since I was 16.
Wow.
Okay, and we thought it'd be legalized, you know, a long, long time ago.
Oh, yeah.
I had to give it up because I became a truck driver, and I had to take test all the time. And I can't risk losing my job, so I quit. It's not addictive. I quit with no problem. I have more problem quit drinking than I do smoking weed.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I really do believe that alcohol is pretty much addictive. Now, by that I mean physically addictive. The fact is, there are certain personality types that can get addicted to having, you know, ice cream after dinner. You know, they're just gonna sit there and, I can't handle it anymore. But, those people are just addictive personalities. And they like marijuana, so they become addicted in their own minds. But that doesn't have anything to do with the addictive qualities of marijuana.
Yeah, there's no such thing as it being addictive. It's just a person and how strong their mind is on what they want to do. But
absolutely.
I think it's absolutely ridiculous that it's not legal throughout the United States. Okay, my wife would prefer that I'd smoke weed instead of drink. Everybody would prefer that I smoke instead of drink. And the day that I retire, if it's not legal where I live now, I live in one of the worst states ever. The biggest redneck state there is Oklahoma, okay? And I don't think it'll ever be legalized there, but I will head out to Colorado, and I'm going to roll me the biggest blunt and sit on the back of my deck and smoke it the day I retire.
Right on, Warren.
Warren, truck drivers don't get thanked enough. You guys keep America moving, and we have everything that we have because you guys move it for us. Thank you for your service.
Thank you. It's a very tough job. It's not what people think, you know?
Do people think driving a truck's easy?
I think people just are like, that thing's too big. It shouldn't be there.
Yeah, well, I pass everybody with their campers and going on vacation and drive over. Today I drove over to Mississippi River, and everybody's on the boats and everything like that. I live on a lake, and I've been on that lake for 12 years, and I've only been on my lake four times.
Just because you're so busy driving, you mean?
Trying to keep up my family. I don't know what the economy's going to do tomorrow.
Yeah, I heard you, brother. Well, drive safe out there, and thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you, Warren. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I mean, do people really think driving a truck's easy? Man, that's some of the hardest work out there. Not only do you have to drive for hours on end, but you also usually have to work on the unloading end as well. You know, you have to throw boxes and things like that. It's a lot of work.
The pay is diminishing. The competition's huge. And yeah. I think that actually these drivers...
And the regulations are terrible.
Oh, yeah. They look at these trucks like, the local municipalities and states. Yeah, they just look at them like big piles of money. They go after them for all kinds of silly stuff. But I think that driverless cars are going to put that industry out of business at some point. So truck drivers, today they're doing everything for us. But at some point they're going to be... moved out of the way. Going to be like blacksmiths.
All right, so you can bring up anything that you want here tonight. In fact, that's what Benjamin's going to do here via Skype, and he's in California. Hello, Benjamin. Do we have Benjamin in California? Going once, Benjamin going twice. I tell you what, you know, sometimes my computer and the sound card just goes bad. We'll look into that, see if we can get him on here in a little bit. But, you know, what great news that here we have the numbers coming out of Colorado. In fact, as Mason Tevert of the Marijuana Policy Project points out, quote, once again, claims that regulating marijuana would leave Colorado in ruins have proven to be unfounded. How many times do marijuana prohibition supporters need to be proven wrong before they stop declaring our marijuana laws are increasing teen use?
Well,
they were wrong when they said regulating medical marijuana would do it, and they were wrong when they doubled down and said making marijuana legal for adults would do it.
A lot of these, okay, first off, when you just look at certain industries, like the medical marijuana industry didn't, to some extent, didn't want to see recreational marijuana come in play. The alcohol industry, private prisons actually had something to say about this.
Oh, yeah.
There were several industries that were dumping money into it. Now, these people are just essentially lobbyists. So everybody knows they're paid liars. No one cares what they say. Well, once they realize they're a lobbyist, but they would disguise themselves sort of as concerned citizens. Now, there's probably, you know, this one in a million concerned citizen that cares enough about marijuana legalization to go out and create some kind of, you know, ruckus or something to actually make, you know, some organization and do something like that. But the vast majority of people that are in the non-decriminalization realm, these people are getting paid by organizations that want to see marijuana remain illegal. Oh, by the way, police unions, huge in this.
Police chiefs as well.
Why in the world would police not want to see, why would they care about what laws they enforce and what they don't enforce, unless, in fact, they really do want to have more arrests?
Right. Well, what is their job? Is their job to enforce the law? Is their job to protect peace? Because if it's protect peace, they've been on the wrong side of that for a long time in a lot of ways. Like, the whole war on drugs creates, you know, it destroys peace on its own. But, you know, the police would generally argue that, oh, I'm just enforcing the law. I'm just doing my job. Well, the people, through the representatives, in the case of Colorado, it's the people directly, these are people who've decided your job needs to be different now. Why are you coming to complain about that? Why are you coming to say, don't change our jobs? Obviously, they have a preference, and their preference is to keep the money rolling in for the war on drugs from the federal government, from the state government, the asset forfeiture confiscations as well.
It creates law enforcement jobs. There's no doubt about that. And I frankly don't
see jobs, too.
Well,
you have to deal with real criminals. You're busting potheads.
I think that anybody who works for the government shouldn't have a vote any longer. Why in the world would an employee get to say how the government's run?
Let's pass that one in New Hampshire, Mark. That's a great idea. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And I also don't think they should be able to come testify in front of state reps, government agents, unless they're, like, specifically invited for some expert testimony. More coming up.
Crashed. The Death of the Dollar. It's a hot new novel that has a lot of people talking. It explores what our government's reaction to a U.S. currency collapse would be. And when the government nationalizes all supply chains in an effort to keep order, the sentiment voiced towards such a tyranny is, we're not picking the fight. The government already did that. We'll just be fighting back for a change. This is a great book, but don't take my word for it. Look at the reviews on Amazon. Bernie says, Crashed is a really terrifying trip. It is thought-provoking. It makes you wonder, what if? Could this happen? Gary Jones adds, this is an excellent book. It is also a little scary because it could very well be true. I hope it's fiction, and Julia Moffat calls it a gripping read and the most exciting, insightful book this year. Crashed is a fast-paced read that has two-thirds of its Amazon reviewers calling for a sequel. This book is totally worth your time. It's well-researched, liberty-oriented, realistic, gripping, and gritty. Do yourself a favor and don't miss this one. Get your copy at Amazon. Crashed, The Death of the Dollar by William Cooper.
It's the heart of summer across America. Thoughts turn to childhood and long days of fun. Everybody would love to feel like a kid again. An HB extract can be a vital tool in your battle to stay vibrant and young, as it supports healthy blood pressure and circulation while balancing cholesterol. GCN and longtime sponsor HB extract want to help keep your heart healthy with the 30 bottles, 30 days summer giveaway. Enter to win by visiting GCNlive.com between now and August 29th and click on the contest
podcast banner in the top left corner of the page. HB Extract has helped tens of thousands of people worldwide feel good again. And they've done it with HB Extract's exclusive formula of wild-crafted and organic herbs. Here's to you enjoying many more long, warm, and fun-filled summers, free of pain and sickness. Visit GCNLive.com and enter to win in the 30-bottle, 30-day summer giveaway with HB Extract. A healthy heart is a happy heart. Sign up now at GCNLive.com.
When commercials come on, don't push the button. Instead, listen. Even if you don't sell things for a living, you're still selling in the various conversations and transactions that make up your busy day. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're a job seeker. So take a lesson from Madison Avenue. Often the fewer words, the more effective the message. Like Jiffy Lube, where you never need an appointment, or the Office Max ad that says, "You supply the ambition, we supply everything else." How about online ticket broker StubHub.com, the way in when it's sold out, or CyberCupid Match.com's seductive, "Go ahead, it's okay to look." How cleverly and succinctly can you distill your message? For more tips, hit SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. Bring up anything you want here toll-free. Live Saturday edition. We'll take your calls at 855-450-FREE. The numbers are showing the prohibitionists were wrong again, and they've been wrong on this one. We've known they've been wrong. We've seen the statistics from Amsterdam, the Netherlands, where teenagers, after marijuana was decriminalized there, did not increase in their use. In fact, usage went down, and we're now seeing the same statistics in Colorado, where usage has been going down ever since, even since before they legalized cannabis for medicinal purposes back in 2001. And since that point, it's continued to go down, the teenage use of cannabis. So the claim that legalizing cannabis would increase the teenagers' use, not true. No evidence for it whatsoever. In fact, the reverse is true. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You can share your thoughts, and we're going to continue with your calls. Let's go to Franklin in West Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live. Franklin.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
I just heard a lot of calls coming in about, they had questions about the cannabis legalization. Well, there's a documentary called The Union, and it's pretty informative, and I think everybody should listen to it and watch it.
What's it about?
It just basically goes back from the 30s when marijuana was first legalized, and the first law ever was actually ordering farmers to grow it for hemp.
Yeah, they, hemp is, hemp's not marijuana in the same sense. I mean, I guess it can cross.
It's the male plant.
Yeah, it's not really. Yeah, it
doesn't have THC in it. Really,
you have to smoke a lot of it. smoke a lot of rope.
You'd probably die from smoke inhalation. Indeed. Before you'd get high off of it. So, anything else you wanted to share about that, Franklin? Go ahead.
Like I said, all these people saying that we're in debt a lot, but marijuana is a $3.5 billion industry.
Well, you can guarantee that marijuana being legalized isn't going to save the politicians from their debt problems. They're just going to keep spending money.
Even if the politicians get more money, they'll just spend that money and then spend more of it that they don't have.
Yeah, for sure. I wouldn't say marijuana being legalized is a solution to the problems of the state as far as their politics and the way politicians behave. But at the very least, it'll keep peaceful people out of the hands of the police in a lot of ways. And that's going to be good for the economy, because if you're not taking marijuana users and putting them in cages and destroying their family lives, then those are people who will be productive members of the economy for the most part, as they currently are today.
All right. Well,
thanks for the call, brother. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. Let's go to Troy. He's in South Carolina. Troy, you're on Free Talk Live.
I had a question. What is the financial side of the business in Colorado in the last 2 years, like it's saying dispensary? What's their financial growth? What are the kind of numbers, if you could tell me?
I have not looked at the numbers in a couple few months, but the growth was pretty tremendous when we looked. I think it was probably around April-May range. We did get kind of a recap on the first 3 months of the year, and there was steady growth.
It has to be pretty good, because there are people now going to Colorado specifically for the purpose of smoking marijuana.
Pot tourism, as it's called. They had the pop. There was like a lady who would you could hire a limousine to take you around, and they literally have pot tours where you go, like, you know, kind of like a pub crawl, except you go to the different dispensaries. You get in the limo and you smoke up in the limo on the way to the next dispensary. So yeah, there's all kinds of neat things that are cropping up. Different jobs are being created, obviously, to create this marijuana industry. Everything from, you know, the dispensary barista, for lack of a better term, the person serving you the marijuana, to the people who are clipping the plants and doing the, you know, the kind of the labor, the hard labor of the growing, to the distribution chain, and the like I said, this lady with the limousine tours, to the kind of the weird stuff that's on the periphery. There's all kinds of jobs being created out there. So it's an exciting time, and dispensaries are popping up. Troy, anything else you want to share?
That's it. I basically have to listen to the show, and kind of hit the. I'm just curious about the numbers, especially with the debt. I mean, each state, if you see the revenue, you can tax this stuff in each state and maybe bring our country down to debt a little bit. But like you said, other politicians and other organizations have been paying people to fight this law, you know, to make it legal, just cause the money, the revenue, like the private sector jails and stuff like that. Like, I think that's just crazy.
Yeah, I think that it's a selling point when you talk to people who are sort of uninformed on the subject, to use, you know, the taxation angle. I think that that's fine, but from my standpoint, I don't think it really makes a difference, because the politicians are getting the percentage of your income that you're willing to give up to them before you pick up a pitchfork and a torch. Hopefully, you know, what their job is to take as much of your money without you complaining about it to enough, you know, without you being willing to do something about it. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's what their job is. They're supposed to steal just enough and tell enough stories about why it's a good idea they steal from you. So this is just sort of an excuse. They're never going to manage their money properly, because they never have managed their money properly.
It's not their money.
There isn't one day in U.S. history where the debt has been paid off. Under Andrew Jackson, and I think he was the 9th president. Somebody's going to get me for this, because he was probably the 8th. It was down to like 5 digits. But this guy is the one who got rid of the Second National Bank. So, you know, now with the Federal Reserve has been in place for more than 100 years, and the currency is basically a debt currency based on the value of your labor. That's what it is. It's a slave note. There is no reason to pay off the debt. Paying off the debt is counterproductive to what bankers and politicians want.
Troy?
Cool. That, you answered all my questions.
Thanks for the call, man. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. Let's continue here. Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Bob's in Ohio, listening to WLOH. Hey, Bob.
Hey, how are you?
Welcome, sir.
Yep. I just wanted to talk about the marijuana thing a minute.
Go for it.
I've been smoking every day for 40 years.
Nice. Today. How's it going?
Oh, just
how's your short-term memory?
not too bad. But no, I've never been arrested. I've never had a traffic ticket. I've always had a job. I've always been fairly responsible. And I've been probably a little lucky.
Yeah, you've been lucky too. There's no doubt about it.
But the marijuana thing, I mean, the government could make so much money off of marijuana if they would just, you know, do it.
But that's the worst part about it. I mean,
not only the farming, but they can make furniture out of it. They can make clothing out of it.
We don't want the government making our furniture, right?
I don't know of any government agency that's ever made furniture.
But I mean, if you get hard up, you could smoke your couch.
Yeah, right. I'm going to pass on that. So, I've never been that hard up for weed.
No, there's hundreds and hundreds of uses for marijuana.
No, you know what you're talking about is hemp, actually. I mean, it's the hemp plant that's really the useful plant as far as it's, you know, really strong fiber, and there's all kinds of neat stuff that can be done with it. But to your earlier point, the worst part about legalization is the fact that most of these legalization schemes involve regulation and they involve taxation of this product. And that's one of the things that's really driving the price up in Colorado and Washington is the fact that it's being taxed. And I don't think that the government should be taxing people who are growing plants and selling plants. I don't think taxes should exist at all. But certainly, if we're going to be decriminalizing or legalizing pot, I'd prefer there be no regulatory structure over top of it. Just get the government the hell out of it. They're already controlling it because it's illegal, and they still want to control it when it's legal. And I don't want them to control it. I don't think that brings good things. It just increases the size of the state.
It's just a plant. I mean, why should they tell us how many tomato plants we can grow in our backyard?
Right. Yeah, I mean it should be an open market kind of thing, or a private business kind
right
of
on
thing.
Bob, thanks for the call tonight. Enjoy your smoke. Appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
Yeah, you know, I mean, think about alcohol licenses for a second. Would your town descend into fiery chaos if for some reason the state ceased to issue alcohol licenses and any business that wanted to, you know, serve you up a Mai Tai could do that?
Of course not. I mean, what would happen? I mean, how much worse could the alcohol situation get as far as people abusing it? I mean, it's not like the state alcohol regulatory commission stops people from buying too much alcohol and going overboard.
The single biggest problem with alcohol in this country has to do with government. The fact is that drinking and driving, it used to be that there was a pub in your little area of town. You could walk to the local pub.
Now it's not zoned for that.
Because zoning kicks in. Now you have to drive to the local bar. So therefore, you know, the people that overserve themselves, well, they're a danger on the roads.
You can't walk home either. You'll get arrested for walking home in some cases. I mean, the consequences won't usually be as bad, but they'll do what they call protective custody around here and basically kidnap you for a night if they think you're too drunk on the streets. The toll-free
number.
That's
better, in my opinion, than getting pulled over.
Like I said, the consequences aren't as bad, but, you know, you can't even walk home from the bar. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Whether it's drug legalization or whatever happens to be on your mind, is the Republican Party changing? And what's the latest with Uber? Coming up.
Lumber Liquidators buys direct from the mills, giving you the largest selection of hardwood flooring at the lowest prices. Right now, choose from over 150 hardwoods on sale, including beautiful and stylish white plank pre-finished red oak for just $179 a square foot. That's less than half what you could pay at other stores. Plus, get Dream Home Laminate and Tranquility Vinyl Flooring for 20% off and bamboo for only $179. Go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest you. More great deals and special 12-month financing available. But hurry, this sale ends Tuesday.
Geico Motorcycle presents Reflections from the Road.
You can't beat the open road, but saving money on motorcycle insurance is a close second. That's why I switched to Geico. Reminds me of the time I switched to a new helmet without a face mask and swallowed a bunch of gnats when I accidentally yawned. Those suckers tasted bad. Unlike Geico Motorcycle Savings, which always taste real good.
Geico Motorcycle Insurance. See how much you could save.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Lil Drums. Every bit as fun as a full-size Nestle drumstick cone and definitely cuter. Visit us at drumstick.com. Vacations are all about family time, but you don't have to leave home to have fun. Take one weekend a month and devote it to family activities. Pull out the board games and puzzles, serve up some treats, or have a picnic. Even without leaving home, you'll feel like you've really had some time away. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, August 8th, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,307, silver opened at $19.84, and Bitcoin is trading around $588.30. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Incorporated, specializing in precious metals since 1977. Online at rrbi.co or by phone at 800-874-9760. In the news, the Austin City Council has approved a $1.25 million settlement for the family of Larry Eugene Jackson, the African-American man killed last year by Austin Police Detective Charles Kleinhardt. Larry Eugene was unarmed and chased down by Detective Kleinhardt after approaching a bank where police were investigating an attempted robbery. Larry left the scene after police began questioning him and a chase ensued. Larry was never lawfully detained and was not a suspect in the bank incident. The council voted 6-1 for the settlement, with only Mayor Lee Leffingwell casting a no vote. According to the Austin American Statesman, Thursday's settlement was the largest of its kind in Austin history. On Saturday, tomorrow, at Brave New Books in Austin, join the Alliance of Austin Agorists as they host Catherine Bleich, Justin and Jessica Armon, and Tracy Ward, four Central Texas residents who have had relative success enterprising in agorist ventures. Join the community from 6 until 10 o'clock for an open discussion on what it takes to find freedom. The event will also feature an agorist farmers market. The Central Texas Healthy Mothers, Healthy Babies Coalition will host a screening of the Milky Way movie tomorrow, Saturday, August 9th, at the Alamo Draft House located on Slaughter Lane. The movie is all about breastfeeding culture and breastfeeding history in the United States. The screening will be followed by a panel discussion and an opportunity to ask questions about the movie and breastfeeding in general. Tickets include lunch and can be purchased on drafthouse.com. The screening begins at 1 p.m. Children are welcome to attend. To learn more, visit keepaustinbreastfeeding.org. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Brave New Books, your local source for all things Bitcoin. Now hosting a Bitcoin ATM, located in Austin, Texas, at 1904 Guadalupe Street, or online, bravenewbookstore.com. And support comes from the notorious activist Michael Cargill, who has a new show called Come and Talk It, live Sunday afternoons at 4 o'clock on 1370 AM in Austin. That's 1370 AM Sundays at 4. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, August 8th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. The FBI has arrested a Homeland Security employee under charges that he solicited sex with a mother and her underage daughter via Craigslist. George Hrvatsky is accused of posting an ad on Craigslist in the casual encounter section looking for a mom interested in allowing a man to teach her daughter about sex. Hrvatsky traded pictures and emails with undercover officers that he believed to be an interested mother. His LinkedIn profile lists him as an inspector with the Department of Homeland Security, specifically the TSA. A TSA spokesman told the San Francisco Gate he was suspended indefinitely and in the process of being fired. Former NSA contractor and whistleblower Edward Snowden has been granted a 3-year residency permit in Russia. One of Snowden's lawyers revealed details of the arrangement at a press conference in Moscow, stating that Snowden is free to move across the country and travel abroad. The news comes on the heels of the Russian government announcing bans of U.S. and EU food, fruits, and vegetables. In an attempt to comply with the Digital Accountability and Transparency Act passed by Congress last year, USAspending.gov released the results of an audit of all government spending and found an astounding $619 billion missing from over 300 different federal programs. Who was the biggest offender? The Department of Health and Human Services. They failed to report nearly $544 billion. Overall, the audit showed that only 2% to 7% of the recorded spending data in 2012 was consistent with agencies' records. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Cabo Bob's, non-GMO chips, homemade tortillas, and no high fructose corn syrup in anything. Visit them at one of their two locations in Austin, 500 East Ben White Boulevard and 2828 Rio Grande near UT Campus. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, August 8th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
A report on obesity rates released this week by the CDC confirmed that millions of courageous Americans continue to overcome the media's persistent pressure to be thin. Researchers told reporters that while the vast majority of film and television continues to portray thin, in-shape people, over 30% of Americans remain resolved in their effort to stand up to idealized images of men and women.
Every day, people are inundated with unvarying images of slim men and women, but millions of heroic Americans continue doing their best every day to maintain BMIs 35 or higher. These people aren't afraid to fly in the face popular culture deems acceptable and bravely eat and drink whatever they want, whenever they want.
In other news, the nation's single men announce a plan to change their bedsheets by 2019. A woman who left the room crying earlier expects to jump back into the party just like that. And a courtroom artist is clearly infatuated with the bailiff. This 2.5 minute long session of immersion therapy is finally complete. Your crippling fear of watching video news recaps should no longer be a problem. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
Free Talk Live. You bring up anything you want. We're here on the live Saturday edition of the program. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. The latest on the ride-sharing companies Uber and Lyft under attack all across the United States by various different local city governments who hate the idea of innovators coming in and bringing change to an old established industry like the taxi cab industry. We've got the latest on that out of Salt Lake here in a little bit. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. In the last hour, we were talking about cannabis and how in Colorado, surprise, surprise, turns out teenagers are smoking less cannabis than, well, ever, at least in the last 10 years. They're looking at the numbers last 15 years. The statistics have been going downward. There's a downward trend, even though medical marijuana passed in 2001. Medical marijuana was more instituted commercially in 2009. And then, of course, in 2012, the vote of the voters voted to legalize. All of that did not increase teenage use. In point of fact, teenage use declined, continued to decline year after year after year. It's fascinating stuff. It flies right in the face of what all the prohibitionists are saying, or many of the prohibitionists say, as to why we need to continue marijuana prohibition. It's for the teenagers. Well, it turns out, it looks like if you legalize pot, that's the best way to get teenagers to stop trying it in the first place. You can share your thoughts. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. All right, we're going to try Benjamin one more time here. He had some technical difficulties earlier, and he's in California via Skype. Our Skype username, by the way, is lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out there. Go ahead, Benjamin.
All right, am I on now?
We have you. Go ahead.
Awesome. Well, before I talk about what I called in for, I'd like to make two quick comments before I derail your current conversation. Okay. One is Andrew Jackson was the seventh president of the United States. And the second is, even if you are, to the audience out there, even if you are not someone who uses drugs or wants to use drugs or whatever, you should be against the war on drugs because it puts you at risk. I am someone who doesn't use drugs, doesn't live in a home where drugs are here, but I am at risk because of the war on drugs. I am at risk of cops breaking into our home and possibly assaulting me. So even if you are not a drug user or don't want to use drugs, you should be against the war on drugs.
It's so bad. You're talking about the last number I saw was 40,000 drug raids per year, and it's likely gone up because that's a rather old number. It's at least several years old. So potentially 50,000+ drug raids per year, you're saying could, obviously with that many drug raids and with somebody who doesn't get in trouble for making a mistake, there are mistakes made. People are killed in their homes in drug raids that have never done drugs in their lives.
It's true.
Right.
They had a baby recently, was scarred for life, fortunately survived, had a stun grenade thrown in its crib by somebody who's not even going to get a day off. It isn't even going to be suspended, isn't going to lose one day's pay over throwing a hand grenade into a baby's crib.
Well, Mark, it's war.
Right.
Okay.
it's a war against American citizens. Yeah.
Well, the funny thing is, it's called a war on drugs, but really it's a very one-sided war. I mean, normally in a war, like the classic definition of war is there's two sides fighting one another, or at least two sides fighting one another. And in the case of the drug war,
one side hasn't figured out who the enemy is yet.
What do you mean by that? One side doesn't know who the
enemy is.
Well,
if there's a war being fought, and that war is being fought against the American people,
yes,
then the American people don't know it. Because they could actually do something about it. Their husbands, wives, children, brothers and sisters are being hired and being given paychecks mm-hmm. by policing agencies to institute a war on drugs that's called war on drugs. And we can see the results, and we've seen the results for decades. And the results generally are not good.
Destroyed lives, dead people, sure.
Higher traffic fatalities, yep. More teen drug use. Everything we've
Worse
talked
drugs.
About in the last hour is being paid for, is jobs for law enforcement officers. We don't need them. They're hurting people. Not all of them. I'm not saying that we don't need that there don't need to be rules that people live by. I'm not claiming that. What I am
I support the police when they arrest bad people who hurt people. If the police are arresting murderers, rapists, arsonists, you know, bad people like that, I'm behind them. Please let me know how I can help with that. But with arresting drug users, arresting other peaceful people, underage drinkers, you know, you name it, anybody who hasn't actually created a victim, I find a real problem. Now, Benjamin, you know, you mentioned that you don't do drugs. Does that include caffeine? Do you ever, you know, have a cup of coffee or?
No, I don't have coffee or tea. I do occasionally have a Dr. Pepper.
Uh-huh.
They are delicious.
So I guess that
minuscule
amount of caffeine. But you know what else?
Wait, Benjamin.
Chocolate.
Ooh,
yeah. Do you feel the effects of caffeine? You know, chocolate and Dr. Pepper.
Yes. Strangely, not when I stop drinking. Like in the past, I drank more soda. Strangely, it's not from withdrawals. It's when I haven't had it for a while, and then I have it. I get a headache the first couple of times I drink it, and then it. I don't have any more until I stop drinking it.
You're better off without it.
Yeah, that's usually how people with a caffeine addiction do it. Is they start using and then they try to stop. They get the headache and that drives them to continue using it. It seems to be a pretty powerful drug.
And I tend to stick to root beer, so it's not a thing.
Give up the sugar too, man.
Hey, do you take aspirin? Do you take things like pharmaceutical drugs?
No, actually. Well, I have. It's not like I refuse to use those, mm-hmm. but I have taken those. But a lot of times, you know, it recommends take two aspirin or whatever, and I'll have one.
Sure.
Because I try not to make my body dependent on the painkillers.
I take a low dose aspirin every single day. There's a lot of evidence that aspirin not only helps you with coronary disease, but also with cancer.
And I'm not against using drugs for medical reasons. I'm not against those. I have no interest in recreational drugs. It's just a personal preference of mine.
Cool.
What'd you call in about?
What else was on your mind?
So the reason I called in is over the last few weeks, months even, there's been a lot of talk about immigration and a lot of securing the border talk.
Sure.
And so I have an idea for those people.
That's because it's election season, so all the politicians are out there pandering to people. They know this is an important issue to people, even though nothing ultimately really ever changes about it. Not that I want more regulations or more cops or any of that
Obama's
stuff.
Obama's deported more people than Bush has.
Is that
Bush
true?
Did, yeah.
That's terrible.
So things have changed.
A great idea that would not require more border guards and would be more effective than a fence. And it's election season, so if you don't hear a politician, if you're for securing the border and you don't hear your politician supporting my idea or something like it, then you know they're not actually for securing the border. And my idea, it's not really even my idea, it was MacArthur's idea, and that is you spread out radioactive cobalt along the border and no living thing will cross it. Simple. Problem solved. No one's going to dig under it. No one's going to jump over it. Nothing. You want the border secure? Radioactive cobalt. And if you're not for that, then you're not really for securing the border. You're
now,
just
what will happen if you...
Nothing good.
No, I mean, I don't know much about radioactive materials, but I don't imagine they glow like they do in the cartoons in real life, all of them. So, you know, if you were to put radioactive cobalt down, people wouldn't necessarily know, right? So you'd...
You'd have to put up warning signs, yeah. I'm sure, but...
What would happen if you were to walk over some radioactive cobalt?
Well, I suppose if it's radioactive enough, you'll just die. And if not, you'll have radioactive sickness.
You'll get poisoned, and you'll probably just die. I mean, you know, small price to pay. I mean, just don't cross the border, and there will be no problem.
Well, we've had people call in and recommend...
I'm not okay with that, by the way. It's a terrible idea.
Motion-detecting machine guns and things like that.
Helicopter pads, yeah.
Helicopters require people.
Underground fences, above-ground fences.
I want to be clear, I am not for this idea.
Okay, good.
I'm just saying that if you are a person who wants to secure the border, then you need to be advocating this idea.
It would certainly be good for the radioactive cobalt companies, whoever they are.
Not really for securing the border. You're just for... increasing the state.
I mean, that's your opinion, and obviously everybody who wants to control the border has their own little plot. What do they think it will to stop people from coming here? You know what it'll take, and thanks for the call, Benjamin. It'll take a total police state, because if you make the United States a horrible place to live and a very uninviting place, then yeah, people are going to decide to just stay where they are, maybe go somewhere else. More coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
Crashed, The Death of the Dollar. It's a hot new novel that has a lot of people talking. It explores what our government's reaction to a U.S. currency collapse would be. And when the government nationalizes all supply chains in an effort to keep order, the sentiment voiced towards such a tyranny is, we're not picking the fight. The government already did that. We'll just be fighting back for a change. This is a great book, but don't take my word for it. Look at the reviews on Amazon. Bernie says, Crashed is a really terrifying trip. It is thought-provoking. It makes you wonder, what if? Could this happen? Gary Jones adds, this is an excellent book. Calls it a gripping read and the most exciting, insightful book this year. Crashed is a fast-paced read that has two-thirds of its Amazon reviewers calling for a sequel. This book is totally worth your time. It's well-researched, liberty-oriented, realistic, gripping, and gritty. Do yourself a favor and don't miss this one. Get your copy at Amazon. Crashed, The Death of the Dollar by William Cooper.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Free Talk Live.
It hasn't been unheard of for the police to insert an instigator. These are things they do, believe it or not. They'll have a plainclothes officer go into the protest and act as though he's one of the protesters, and then the plainclothes officer will start something with another one of the police.
Oh, come on. This sounds like a conspiracy theory now.
This is not a conspiracy theory. These are confirmed occurrences. Let's give the cops a benefit of the doubt and say it really was some instigator starting stuff with the cops. Does that mean that it's appropriate to flush every single person out of the park with rubber bullets, tear gas, and other sorts of offensive devices?
Doesn't seem like it to me.
Wouldn't it make more sense to stop the person who's instigating, to, you know, put a stop to those specific individuals?
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateurs, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition of the program. Of course, plenty of time for you with your thoughts. We'll also give you the latest on the ride shares under attack from various different city governments around the country. This one's going to be from Salt Lake. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and you can join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com. Now, if you're online at all, you really need to think about your privacy, especially in all the with all the revelations from Edward Snowden and other leakers that are now coming out, apparently, with more information about the government and, you know, the kind of information they're collecting on you. You can stop information collection, or at least by your internet service provider, by signing up for ProXPN over at proxpn.com/FTL. But ProXPN does much more than that. What it does is it encrypts your internet connection. So your ISP has no idea what you're doing anymore. They can't, therefore, log what you're up to, which they're probably doing right now. They're probably logging everything you do. Every website you visit, every search term you enter might be being kept for up to 5 years in some cases by your ISP. ProXPN puts a stop to that through encrypting your data connection. And that also means that other nosy people, like people with Wi-Fi packet sniffers, maybe sitting across the coffee shop from you, trying to crack into and maybe look at your credit card numbers that you might be buying stuff online with, etc. Those people will be flummoxed and stopped by the encryption, as well as maybe naughty administrators who are snooping in on you, that kind of thing. So you can stop that. ProXPN.com/FTL. Go get signed up. Get their free software for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, as well as Android devices. And you can also upgrade to their premium account. When you do that, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can connect to, and you can even privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. So useful and so affordable, down to as low as $5 a month when you buy their annual plan with our discount code FTL20. That's FTL20 to get 20% off for the lifetime of your account. There's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And ProXPN does not keep records of your online surfing habits. So go to proxpn.com/FTL. Use promo code FTL20 as we continue here with you and your thoughts. David is in San Francisco. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, David.
Hey, greetings.
Welcome.
Hey, you know, a funny thing happened to me the other day. I heard you talking about the hemp. Yeah, I don't know if either of you all do bicycle riding, but the other day I was riding my bike and... you know what drafting is?
Drafting is getting in behind a vehicle to reduce your, the wind resistance.
Like behind a big truck, for instance, would be a real good place to do drafting. It's also highly dangerous because...
Yeah. Sounds like a terrible idea for a bicycle, but go ahead.
Because if the truck stops, obviously, the closer you are to it, the less time you have to react. So go ahead.
Sure. Well, in bicycle racing, drafting is a major part of it. So the other day I was riding down the trail, and there was a fellow in front of me that was smoking a fat one, and it was quite a fat one. If you've ever seen what's called a spliff, that's what he was doing. And I realized what he was doing, so I made a point to pace him and draft. So I was doing actual drafting.
That's cute. You got anything else for us, David?
Well, yeah, where I was going to go with this, the economy of, first of all, if you were to study how it was outlawed, William Randolph Hearst was he and George Bush's great-granddad, a guy named Sam Bush, were involved in the origins of the Spanish-American War. And Sam Bush was a purchasing agent for the Spanish-American War, and they figured out that they could profiteer from it forever. So they made a point to drag that war on as long as they could, seize as much land as they could. And William Randolph Hearst ended up with endless forests, not only in Mexico, but in the Philippines as well. And so he didn't know what he could do with his forests. I mean, lumber was an industry, of course, but he figured out that if he was to make paper out of it, his paper would be too expensive. So he decided that he would have to destroy the hemp industry, and hemp paper is not only high quality, but it's cheap. And so
right, and it doesn't take as long to grow weeds as it does big trees.
Sure, I mean it's going to take a decade at the very least to maybe even more, two decades, close to a lifetime to get these trees to make paper. You can have the hemp to do it in a season.
Yeah, so you're right. It was William Randolph Hearst, the infamous newspaper
among
man.
Among others.
Among others. There was the DuPont Company as well that was involved. Those are two of the biggies. These are the guys who lobbied the federal government, and very successfully, to outlaw marijuana back in the 30s.
Right, and so when you start to look at it from that direction, you realize why they did it and their vested interest in it. But what's even uglier about it, I know that global warming's happening. I see it happening all the time, and I see plenty of proof of it. And when you start looking at how trees are being decimated worldwide, they've been destroying the lungs of the earth for the last 25 years down in the rainforests in South America, and they're doing the same in Africa as well. And the idea that these are the lungs of the earth, and if you destroy all of these trees, that we're going to be in a sorry shape. You see these not only the hurricanes.
Do you think marijuana is some kind of solution to the destruction of megaflora?
Well, it's a solution to it because when you look at the desertification, if hemp had not been outlawed, you could go down to Utah, you could go to Arizona, Nevada, many of these states that they need any bush they can get. They need any scrap of shade they can get. And the fact that they've been outlawing it for 50, 75 years means that a weed, something that in Missouri, which is where I come from, the Department of Fish and Game in Missouri had actually decided to not agree with Richard Nixon in 1972 or so when he created this war on drugs. And they were not going to eradicate hemp in Missouri because it was too important for game birds.
While I'm with you that hemp absolutely needs to be legalized, as do as do the rest of the drugs, but hemp's not a drug. Anyway, hemp should be legalized for the purposes of industrial whatever. I mean, there's all kinds of things you can do with hemp. But just to be clear, I mean, forests can be regrown, and the people who own forests, they do regrow them over time. It would be kind of stupid to just
many times the rainforests
cut.
And these sorts of things are being cleared cut because they aren't owned. Right.
That was where I was going to go. If there's forests being clear cut in the United States, it's usually on government managed land where the government managers will essentially lease out the land to some sort of company that's going to come in and literally ravage it and then leave the land after their lease is up, so they don't have the same interest in continuing the sustainability of that land. So thank you for the call, David. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Tom in Wisconsin. You're on Free Talk Live listening to the Mike 92.1. Hey, Tom.
Well, hello, gentlemen. I'm mostly with you on the topic of freedom and liberty and so on. But at some point, this proposition can be carried too far.
And which proposition?
Humans can just be too free.
You mean the proposition of human freedom?
Well, for instance, yeah, I should be free to dump the used oil from my car anywhere, right?
Nope, absolutely not. That would be a property violation.
Let's talk about that with you here in a moment, all right? We'll bring you back here, Tom, and we can get into that. It's a good question. Should people be free to destroy? People be free to pollute? Well, I don't think so. 855-450-FREE. You can take control. It's Free Talk Live.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
The warning signs.
At first, he made me feel special. He promised he'd look after me, provide for my future. He broke every promise he made.
Millions of Americans afflicted.
I was ready to leave, but he told me he'd change. So I gave him another chance. I was such a fool.
The consequences.
Things only got worse. He started making my decisions for me about my job, my kids' education, my money. My safety, my future. He took away my choices, but I kept going back to the same politicians.
The diagnosis? Battered voter syndrome.
I fell for the same old lies. They were just playing with my emotions, telling me what I wanted to hear. That's not right.
Stop the insanity of voting for the same old abusers. Declare your independence from the two-party system and join the New Hampshire Liberty Party today. At nhliberty.info.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
This is a national health care alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. So if you're on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. We also have other pain-relieving braces, too, for your shoulder, ankle, or back. You may be eligible to get these items and more at little or no out-of-pocket cost. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to help you, so please call now. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, and you can bring up whatever you want. We're here on the live Saturday edition with you tonight. Ian here.
And Mark.
You know what? We've added so many new radio stations over the last week, Mark. I have to admit, I've lost track of which ones I've welcomed on the air or not. So,
that's
welcome.
Awesome.
Welcome to WZTK 105.7 in Alpena, Michigan, in case I forgot you last week. They're taking our Saturday show and delay broadcasting us a few hours. If you're new to Free Talk Live, you know, listen in for a little bit. Or just pick up the phone and call in. We don't really care. You can call in and bring up any topic that might happen to be on your mind. Those other talk show hosts, they don't want to let you call in about what you want. Those other talk show hosts want you to call about what they want to talk about. Just because we're talking about ending prohibition, cannabis legalization, things like that here on the air, doesn't mean that you have to call and talk about that. So join us here on the phones at 855-450-FREE. That's the Pro XPN toll-free line. And join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. ExpressCoin. What is it, Mark? What can people do at ExpressCoin.com?
Well, if they go to ExpressCoin.com, they have the opportunity to buy a multitude of different cryptocurrencies. Now, the one you've likely heard of is Bitcoin, but there are lots of other cryptocurrencies out there. The ones that they sell at ExpressCoin.com are Dogecoin, Litecoin, Blackcoin, Darkcoin, and there's big followings behind these other cryptocurrencies. I'm of the opinion Bitcoin's definitely leading the way and likely to be, since it's first to market, likely to be the one that wins over. But I could be wrong. Many people believe that these other cryptocurrencies have their values too. And ExpressCoin.com is a great place to get cryptocurrencies. If you've been hearing about cryptocurrencies on the news, you probably don't know where to get them. Well, this is the place to do it. They're inexpensive, completely legal, easy to use, fast. They pride themselves on their customer service, so much so that they've just redesigned the website so the back end of their website allow them to be even more focused on meeting your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with a money order, check, or wire transfer. Or you can do it by going and making a deposit directly in a bank account at a local credit union that has shared branching. You'll want to call ahead with the credit union and make sure they've got shared branching. That's important. But just first, go to ExpressCoin.com and start your process there. So if you make a deposit in a local credit union, you can have your Bitcoins or other cryptocurrencies within a business day. That's how fast they can do it for you at ExpressCoin.com. You can even do it from your smartphone by downloading the app, ExpressCoin.com, available in Canada. Use coupon code FTL to get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrencies at no fee at all. I told you they had low fees, but you can get up to $40 worth at no fee by using coupon code FTL at ExpressCoin.com.
And I think you can use that code more than once, right? So like if you bought less than $40 this week and then you wanted to buy less than $40 next week,
I believe
you can get
so.
No fee. Very cool stuff at ExpressCoin.com. Let's go back to Tom. He's in Wisconsin in Madison listening to WXXM. There, the Mike 92.1. Now, Tom, you had called in to bring up some objections to the ideas of liberty or libertarianism or whatever you want to call it. The idea that you should be free to live your life how you want so long as you don't harm anyone else. And that's where the answer, I think, to your first question comes in, where you talked about, well, could I just pour oil all over wherever I want to pour it, you know, on my own? And no, you know, that would be polluting somebody's property. And so therefore, that could be, you know, a tort against you and you could be held liable for that.
You could pour oil all over your property, but it would still likely leach down into the soil and affect other people's property. So that would still be a property rights violation.
Yeah. So, I mean, liberty-minded people really respect the idea of other people's property. That's one of the real core tenets of the ideas of freedom, is that, you know, you have rights and you should be free to do what you want so long as your actions do not infringe upon the rights of another individual. So that always has to be taken into consideration.
Well, I feel totally lectured now. I live on a street where kids are out playing, and apparently you guys think that I should be able to just drive 90 miles an hour down my street where kids might be out running.
What would make you think that?
Hold on. And I should be able to possess a shoulder-held missile launcher. Is that your belief?
Yeah.
I think you should be able to have the latter, I think you should be able to possess whatever kind of weapon you want to protect yourself.
And you should be completely responsible for the use of that.
Yeah, as long as you aren't endangering people. But as far as driving 90 miles an hour down a residential street, there would likely be rules on private property about how fast you could go.
Maybe even a person with a shoulder-mounted weapon that would blow your car up.
I love you guys. Take care.
Thanks, Tom, for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Look, I think that there does become an issue where, like, let's say the classic example of the weapons that people shouldn't be allowed to have is the nuclear weapon, right? What if some, you know, home inventor tinkerer is building his own nuclear weapon in his garage? Should he be allowed to do that?
Well, first off, what are you going to do about it if they are? Because there's probably a home tinkerer in the United States right now that has built a nuclear weapon.
Maybe.
And you don't know about it, you little worry wart.
That's true. Yeah. But what are you going to do?
But let's talk about nuclear weapons. Okay, so a nuclear weapon cannot be employed in a defensive manner. Mm. You cannot use it in a targeted manner.
Right.
So
it's wholesale destruction.
It's wholesale destruction. You cannot implement a nuclear weapon, the use of a nuclear weapon, and not hurt
innocent
people or destroy property that isn't yours. So therefore, I'm of the opinion that a nuclear weapon, you know, there's no reason for it. The very possession of it is a threat against your neighbors. And you have, if you've implemented a threat, if you've issued a threat, as far as I'm concerned, it's, you know, violence can be used against you. Force can be used against you at that point.
Yeah, and having a rocket-propelled grenade or some sort of rocket launcher device that
you could simply use it to somebody going 90 miles an hour running kids over on your street.
That you're toting around outside could be upsetting to the neighbors, and so therefore it wouldn't be unreasonable to have deed restrictions that prohibit people from brandishing, you know, certain firearms, if that's the kind of neighborhood you want to live in. You could also live in a neighborhood where everybody's cool with you just taking it out in the backyard and shooting off some rockets. I mean, so you never know. There should be all choices.
People are doing target practice where I live every week.
Yep, that's true. We're in New Hampshire, and so it's fairly common here out in the woods. Let's go to Charles, listening in West Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Charles.
Hi, guys.
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
Oh, several things. Let's start with the paper. And the trees. You said that what trees were being cut were usually being cut on government land.
What I said was if there's clear cutting going on, meaning that trees are being harvested in an unsustainable manner, in that the trees are not being replanted after being cut down, that kind of thing, it's usually not happening on private property. It's usually happening when, as I understand it, government land managers are leasing out land to companies who are not taking good care of it because they don't own it, so they don't have a stake in its long-term sustainability. That's what I was saying. Does that make sense?
Yeah, but it's kind of the opposite around here.
Is that right?
If you count companies as private, they're cutting every tree that's big enough to put on a truck.
Well, are you talking about lumber companies, or are you talking about companies trying to, you know, make room to build new, you know, buildings and things like that?
Timber companies.
They're what companies? Labor.
Timber companies.
Timber companies. You're saying they're
Why
just
Why are
cutting
they cutting numbers? All the trees on their land and not replenishing them?
Because they're stupid, more or less. But
well, then they're going to go out of business.
Well, they figure on that. They're going to clear everything around here, move out for 40 years, and then come back and start where they did 60 years ago. But around here, it takes a tree. This is rocky country. This is Appalachia. This is hard Appalachia. Mm-hmm. This is the only state that is totally Appalachia. It touches nothing but Appalachia.
Okay.
When the first settlers come into this country, not the first ones, the first white ones, Europeans, oh, they didn't see beautiful big timber. They saw profit. They saw profit.
Well, you know, as far as I'm concerned, if what you're saying is true, and we're going to take your word for it, Charles, if what you're saying is true and that there are these dumb companies out there just destroying their own property and not replenishing the trees there, and that's their job is to sell timber, doesn't make sense to me. But if that is happening, then the best way to combat that is not with a government, not to go in with the threat of force and violence to try to stop people. But in my opinion, the best way to combat it would be to buy property and protect the trees there. Thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate it.
That's what the Nature Conservancy is doing and several other large organizations.
Audubon Society does that as well.
Doesn't Ducks Unlimited own quite a bit of land?
Yeah, I think that's true too. Yeah. 855-450-FREE. You take control here. It's Free Talk Live.
This is Mark Edge of Free Talk Live, and I've got something awesome to share with you. I've recently joined Liberty.me. It's an online city devoted to people who love liberty. Break free of the flame wars and bridge-dwelling denizens of Facebook. You deserve better. You deserve a friendly, ad-free social network where you can chat 24 hours a day with like-minded souls around the world. Attend live interactive classes with experts on economics, finance, politics, and money. Access a vast library of books and discuss them with your reading group. Better your life with exclusive self-help guides on investing, self-defense, homeschooling, security, healthcare, saving money, and starting a business. Become a libertarian luminary yourself and get paid in the process by publishing your works on Liberty.me. Get tipped via PayPal and Bitcoin.
The first step towards freedom is to invest in yourself. Start your free 30-day trial now at Liberty.me.
I love being a member of Liberty.me, and I think you will too. The first month is free. Sign up and say hello.
It's the heart of summer across America. Thoughts turn to childhood and long days of fun. Everybody would love to feel like a kid again. An HB extract can be a vital tool in your battle to stay vibrant and young, as it supports healthy blood pressure and circulation while balancing cholesterol. GCN and longtime sponsor HB extract want to help keep your heart healthy with the 30 bottles, 30 days summer giveaway. Enter to win by visiting GCNlive.com between now and August 29th and click on the contest banner in the top left corner of the page. HB Extract has helped tens of thousands of people worldwide feel good again, and they've done it with HB Extract's exclusive formula of wild-crafted and organic herbs. Here's to you enjoying many more long, warm, and fun-filled summers, free of pain and sickness. Visit GCNlive.com and enter to win in the 30-bottle, 30-day summer giveaway with HB Extract. A healthy heart is a happy heart. Sign up now at GCNlive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary at fpp.cc, as well as weekly news in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc, and books at shop.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. It's weusecoins.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition where you can take control of the airwaves. Of course, you can do that 7 days a week. We do the show every single night. If you don't get it every night on your local talk radio station, just give them a call and ask them real nicely to add some Free Talk Live if they take none of us, or none of us rather. And if they take some already, then ask for more, because again, we do it 7 nights a week. We're live from 7 to 10 at night Eastern Time. If you're not hearing us live, you can make a note on your calendar and call in on the next show during our live hours, and then you can listen to yourself later on if your local radio station is playing us back in what we call in the business delay broadcast. So join us here on the phones, toll-free number 855-450-FREE. Join us via Skype. Our Skype username is LRN. LRN.FM. We've talked about everything from legalizing cannabis to rocket launchers and nuclear weapons, bike drafting. We've been all over the place here tonight. You can bring up anything you want here. We're going to go right back into your phone calls and thoughts. Sohel is on the line in California. You're on Free Talk Live. Hi, Sohel.
Thank you. How are you, sir?
Welcome. I'm doing well. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Okay. I would like to talk to American people about what's happening there in Iraq. And it's really tragic. I mean, somehow we could blame the Iraqis themselves for making a lot of mistakes. And however,
when you say it's a tragic situation, are you referring to the group that's been taking over the cities down
ISIS.
There? ISIS?
Yes, okay. Exactly. Like, there's a lot of massacres. Innocent people are dying. And there's also the problem is Iraq. Like, Americans need to know about
it. It's a little hard to understand what you're saying. I don't know if you're talking.
Yeah, can you back up just a little bit from your phone, Sohel?
I don't know if that's what the problem is, but go ahead.
Okay, I'll try. Actually, I'm a person with a disability, so it's hard for me to move. I hope you are understanding me.
You have some sort of a disability in speaking?
I have muscular dystrophy.
Yikes. So. Yeah, it is. You know, we're understanding most of what you're saying, but it's kind of a challenge. So if you could get your thoughts out quickly, I'd appreciate it.
Okay, thank you.
All right, thanks.
I have published here in the United States two books, but unfortunately my books are in Arabic. They deal with the first book title is called titled The Criticism of the Muslim Mind, and I criticize the Sunnah and the Shiites, and also we have an ethnic problem in Iraq.
Ethnic problem?
Yes, ethnic culture. And
I think the problem in Iraq is the U.S. government is the number one problem there. But I thank you, Sohel, for the call tonight. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And I always feel bad when people call in with speech impediments. You know, I want to give people their chance to say what they want, but at the same time, you know, we have to do a radio show, and it has to be something that people can listen to. So if you've got a speech impediment, maybe you should just send us an email or shoot us, you know.
Yeah, it's tough.
Some sort of digital communication on the Facebook page.
You know, I mean, the Iraq situation, George Bush, 43, kind of took off the solution off the table before it ever started. He made a deal with Turkey that they could use their bases, but what they wouldn't do is they wouldn't cut Iraq up into ethnic quadrants like the Kurds, the Shiites, and the Sunnis. Well, you can imagine that the Sunnis, not real happy about having the Shiite majority basically running a government where the majority rules.
Mm-hmm.
You know, democracy is all well and good until you're in the minority, and then it really stinks. Ask black people. Yeah, that whole being in a minority thing really stunk, and it's not that hot now. And you know, Kurds, they're largely left alone, but there's a lot of sort of get back from the Saddam Hussein era that the Shiites want to have against the Sunnis. So it really just should have been, if they were going to cut up land masses at all, they should have you know, let these ethnic groups figure it out on their own.
Yeah, absolutely. And the U.S. government should have stayed the hell out of it, because odds are good that Saddam Hussein, in whatever reign he might have had he continued to be in charge this whole time, probably wouldn't have presided in as many slaughters of innocent people.
Well, the checks
the
he got from the United
has.
States government certainly helped with that.
Yeah, let's continue here. We go to Rod in New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live, Rod.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
You know who I am. How's the situation in Iraq?
Not what great.
It's not good, is it?
No.
I mean, if we go over there.
You're going to Iraq?
If we don't go over there, it's a problem.
Well, Well, I imagine that there are a lot of people that fought over there during Operation Desert Storm and all the other operations that have gone on. I imagine they probably feel like they fought and had their friends die for nothing. And it would be difficult to argue that at this point.
Right, right. But how can we protect the children and women over there? What's happening?
Allow them to immigrate. Open up the borders in the United States and allow people from Iraq and, frankly, children from around the world to be able to come here with their parents, build a better life. I don't recommend that they get a bunch of free handouts unless churches and community organizations want to do that. But, I think that most of us here are here because people moved from tragic circumstances in their home country to come here to a place where they could without government help, be able to build a better life for themselves. And that's the American dream. And the American dream's been crushed long ago.
Right. I agree with you on that. People have been coming to our country, to live. I mean, they know we have a free country, and they've been doing it since the 20s.
But longer than that, but yes.
Rod, anything else you want to share tonight?
No. I just wanted to know your opinion about that. How we could work things out, to protect some of the women and children over there.
I think that people who want to help in other countries should be free to help, right? Like if you want to go over and join up with some sort of mercenary group, you should be able to do that. You should go over and join up with some sort of mercy group. You should be able to do that and try to escape people.
In most
from
cases,
that.
You are free to do that.
Yeah, but people shouldn't be forced, right? So people who don't want to get involved or don't want to pick a side or they're not sure who's the right side to join or whatever, they shouldn't be forced to go in and help these people. They shouldn't be forced against their will. But I actually absolutely support helping people in need. And Rodney,
I've been listening to your show for the last 3 weeks. You haven't seen me around. I'm trying to understand a lot about you, and I'm starting to understand some of it. Just so you know that.
Thanks. I appreciate the open-mindedness, Rod. And I thank
you. You know who I am.
I figured it out finally. Actually, I didn't at the beginning of your call.
I'm trying to understand everything and look for ways to make the world better.
That's what we're all doing. Thanks for the call tonight, Rod. I do appreciate hearing from you tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Rod is one of our neighbors here in the Keene area,
awesome.
As a matter of fact. And it sounds like he's an open-minded guy, and that I appreciate about his approach here tonight.
I hope that I'm open-minded. I hope people can call in with new ideas. I mean, frankly, I feel like having done this show for 12 years, I often feel like I've heard the ideas before, but I try to sit and listen to them. One of the difficulties I have is I really dislike government solutions where force people to do things. Like, for instance, right now we're sitting, there are some people in this country, many people in Washington, that want to go over to Ukraine and solve that problem with guns and bombs. Mm. But the American people are not interested in it. This is Afghanistan was the longest war in U.S. history. They are sick of and tired of the bloodshed and the waste and just no solutions that come from war. And so they're not going to put up with it. But
historically, Americans have not been fans of intervening.
I don't know whether that's the case. The fact is there's something like...
It certainly is the reason why Woodrow Wilson was elected. He promised to keep people out of war.
Well, yeah.
World War One.
Indeed. But the fact is the United States has been at war far more years than it has not been at war.
Well, just because the government goes to war doesn't mean that's what the people want, right?
Well, if you live in a democracy where the government is of the people, by the people, for the people, then it shouldn't be.
But that's not the way it actually works.
I know. It's a lie. Right. And I don't know how to deal with that. How do I deal with a government that is a lie and a nation of people that don't believe that it's a lie?
Well, we're doing all we can. I mean, we expose as many lies as we can. We can't expose them all. There's too many to expose them all. But if we can expose enough, then it shows that there's a clear pattern of lying and that, hey, you shouldn't trust these guys, whether they call themselves Republicans or Democrats, whether it's, Barack Obama or George W. Bush or whoever the next guy or lady ends up being. Don't trust them.
They're politicians. It's synonymous with liar.
And that includes Rand Paul. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450.
He wants the convicts to be able to vote, for God's sake.
3733. Hey, we've got plenty of time for you. Coming up here in hour number three, this is Free Talk Live. You take control of the airwaves.
Safety, safety, safety. I'm saying it three times. Studies show you need to hear something three times to remember it. So remember, safety, safety, safety is important to me, me, me. That's why I love Grainger. Grainger has the products to help keep our facilities safe and people safer. Say it with me, kid. Safety, safety, safety from Grainger, Grainger, Grainger. When you think safety, think Grainger. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgrainger.com/safety or stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Lumber Liquidators buys direct from the mills, giving you the largest selection of hardwood flooring at the lowest prices. Right now, choose from over 150 hardwoods on sale, including beautiful and stylish white plank pre-finished red oak for just $179 a square foot. That's less than half what you could pay at other stores. Plus, get Dream Home Laminate and Tranquility Vinyl Flooring for 20% off and bamboo for only $179. Go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest you. More great deals and special 12-month financing available. But hurry, this sale ends Tuesday.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, August 9th, 2014. Silver is trading at $19.89 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,310 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $589. Antiwar.com reports, the end of the 72-hour Gaza ceasefire and the resumption of hostilities has not ended the ongoing Cairo peace talks, though Hamas spokesman Sami Zohri expressed serious concern about whether Israel was simply wasting our time. According to Hamas, the Israeli delegation rejected the vast majority of Palestinian demands, including all calls to ease the blockade of the Gaza Strip and to open a UN-managed seaport. Even the demands that weren't rejected were simply left unanswered, and Hamas believes that was evidence that Israel was dragging its feet to try to get the ceasefire to expire without a deal. European officials have offered to serve as observers for a seaport with a single route between Gaza and Cyprus, though so far it is unclear if Israel will allow this to happen. For years, Israel has responded to attempts to reach Gaza by sea with military force. In the spirit of Motorhome Diaries and Liberty on Tour, I intend to take the message of peace, love, and liberty on the road. During the 104-day trip, I'll be visiting at least 10 cities across the country, speaking to people about the ideas of peace, love, and liberty. To find out more about the tour or to donate, visit GoFundMe.com/FPPCC. That's GoFundMe.com/FPPCC. Reuters reports a former New Jersey Republican official who once worked with Governor Chris Christie was found dead along with her husband inside their home, according to officials on Friday, in what appeared to be a murder-suicide. Police discovered the bodies of Joan Bramall and her husband John inside their Denville home on Thursday, but the Morris County Prosecutor's Office declined to identify the bodies until Friday. An autopsy revealed that Joan Bramall was shot to death and her husband died of a self-inflicted gunshot wound, according to the prosecutor's office. The statement did not say that John shot his wife, though it did say that there was no evidence of any intruders in the home and added that the community was not at risk. The prosecutor's office could not be immediately reached to provide further detail or clarification, and it said in a statement it would not likely provide more information on Friday. Bramhall was the former Morris County clerk and stepped down in 2013 after her 14th consecutive year in the position. She had previously served as the chairwoman of the Morris County Republican Committee. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. The Washington Post reports American warplanes and drone strikes against militants in northern Iraq put the U.S. military back in action in the skies over Iraq less than 3 years after the troops were supposedly withdrawn by President Obama and he declared the war to be over. The strikes were limited in scope but helped temper days of building panic across the north of the country as militants with ISIS sliced through a string of towns and villages scattered on the outskirts of the Kurdish region and sent tens of thousands of civilians fleeing for their lives. The airstrikes also presented the first significant challenge yet to months of unchecked expansion by the Al-Qaeda offshoot, which has swept through much of Iraq and neighboring Syria over the past year, annihilating its opponents, capturing valuable resources, and declaring the creation of an Islamic caliphate in a nation-sized chunk of territory. In Washington, the Pentagon announced three separate strikes by multiple aircraft against militant positions it said were firing on Kurdish forces protecting Erbil, saying they had successfully eliminated artillery, a mortar position, and a convoy of extremist fighters. Kurdish media and officials who said the attacks had a devastating impact on militant positions claimed other unconfirmed attacks that were farther afield. U.S. officials also stressed that the American intervention was narrowly aimed at the protection of American diplomats and officials living in Erbil, where the U.S. consulate has swelled with evacuees from the embassy in Baghdad and where the U.S. military runs a joint operations center alongside Kurdish forces. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
From the day an ancient cave dweller painted yet another f***ing elk hunt on a wall in 15,000 BC, to Gary Marshall's 1974 discovery of 13 weather-beaten North Dakotan coal miners that would go on to become the cast of Happy Days, The Onion looks back at This Week in History. On June 17, 1954, the effects of the previous month's historic Supreme Court ruling in Brown versus the Board of Education provided black students with the educational opportunity of experiencing racism firsthand in desegregated schools. Up until that point, African American pupils could only endure racial slurs and death threats in city streets or near their homes. And on June 24, 1784, 13-year-old Edward Warren took the first hot air balloon flight, becoming the first American to urinate on a crowd from 100 feet in the air. And that was what happened this week in history.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Take control of the airwaves. Here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It is the live Saturday edition of the program, and joining you in the studio tonight, Ian here.
And Mark.
Don't forget, you can join us online at freetalklive.com. You scroll down the page there at freetalklive.com, you'll see different news stories submitted by listeners just like you. You can do it through our Reddit-based site. Number one story right now, top story, submitted by Surly Curmudgeon.
We probably have more than one of those.
Activists fly anti-surveillance airship over the NSA's Utah data center.
Oh, God.
It's a video from YouTube, so you can go check that out. And vote on other things. So you can vote up what you like and vote down what you don't. In fact, the story I have about the ride shares, I came right off our front page from Desert Coyote. And I do want to get to that story if we get the chance. The Uber and Lyft companies still continue to be under fire in various different cities around the country. We'll give you an update on their situation here. We've been all over the map as far as topics tonight. Everything from legalization of pot, apparently resulting in teenagers smoking less pot in Colorado.
It's amazing.
And, yep, and then, you know, other stuff like rocket launchers, the freedom to own them, etc. will continue. Immigration was brought up as well. You can bring up anything that you want. Brian's in Wyoming. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Brian.
Yeah, hi.
Hey.
Just one thing I think that some of the people, like maybe Tom before, people were kind of missing is one solution that solves everything is the non-aggression principle.
That's it. We're also called the zero aggression principle.
Yeah, for those who don't understand what it is, it's just basically, you know, you don't mess with my rights, I don't mess with your rights. And I just wanted to comment real quick on how that could be applied to almost all the topics that Ian just listed off, like such as, let's say, borders. You know, the non-aggression principle could be applied there. First of all, you know, just stop giving the people welfare to come over here.
Right. So, I think that's the biggest solution. If many of the problems that come with people moving here for a better life is hey, well, we got to give them this free stuff. Well, you've got a welfare problem. You don't have an immigration problem.
Yeah, but in the war on drugs, which is, you know, in direct violation of the non-aggression principle, right?
And the war on drugs causes where they live to be inhospitable. People don't want to take responsibility for the war on drugs. The United States government has prosecuted throughout the Western Hemisphere. And, you know, that's like, well, I have no idea why this is happening. Why are these people coming here? Their villages are on fire. They can't have any good, they can't build any lives for themselves.
Yeah, well, exactly. And then just to jump to another, you know, quick thing is like driving 90 miles an hour through a suburban neighborhood. That's in direct violation of the non-aggression principle because you're aggressing on not only people trying to cross the street, but their kids and all that. So, you know, that's
well, I wouldn't say driving fast is a violation of the non-aggression principle because you can still drive fast and drive safely, and it's also up to the kids to learn to look both ways before they cross the damn street. I think parents need to teach their kids and or keep an eye on them if they're too young to learn that particular rule.
But I think residential areas would probably have speed limits up.
Private property owners could certainly have the ability to put up a speed limit and put in speed tables or bumps or whatever enforcement they felt were necessary to curb the speeds through the neighborhood. Don't make it a through street either, and then it's far less likely that, you know, you're going to have people doing that stuff.
I live on a major road here in New Hampshire. They don't slow the cars down below 55 miles an hour for my house because I have a 6-year-old.
Yeah. So there you go. I don't think it's aggression, but it could be a property rights violation to go that fast.
Yeah, but somebody is violating that if they're putting doing that through a place where they know, you know, that kids could possibly be in danger. So
I would agree.
You know, I kind of see that as you kind of are aggressing on somebody. I mean, if you're out on the highway and, you know, you're driving 90, 100, you know, I've lived in Montana before where they just recently actually made speed limits.
Yeah, what a shame.
And actually, in Montana, the accidents went up once they actually applied speed limits.
It's true.
To the roadways.
Human freedom works.
Yeah.
It's counterintuitive in many ways. I mean, isn't it surprising that accidents would go up when they put speed limits in place?
How about those crazy videos? I don't know if y'all have seen these, but I've seen a couple of them online. I don't know what country they're coming out of, but some country where there's like this huge intersection and no traffic lights or control devices whatsoever, and you just watch as these cars manage to make it through there, and, you know, without causing a single accident. It looks like crazy chaos, but it's really this organized, almost a self-organizing system.
Well, I think traffic circles are, to me, it's a step up. A lot of people don't like them at all, but they.
I'm not talking about a traffic circle. I just mean an open intersection with people just coming into it.
Mark's really right. They put those in a few areas that I've lived, and it actually decreased accidents, and you actually don't.
I don't know if they decrease accidents.
Down, but,
have you seen an accident on a traffic circle?
I've heard they happen quite often.
Yeah, the traffic circles for the four ways.
I've heard they happen quite often because people don't know how to use them and they get confused and they don't know which lane to turn out of or turn into and that kind of stuff.
I think they've been awesome.
I like them. They work very well. I'm not saying they're worse than stoplights.
If you can't figure out a traffic circle, maybe you shouldn't be operating a motor vehicle.
I'm with you.
A ton and a half death machine.
There's a lot of people who shouldn't be operating motor vehicles.
Indeed,
who
but
are
the government licenses them.
Yeah, sure. Absolutely. As long as you can fog a mirror, you can pretty much drive a car.
Well, you have to be able to find the mirror.
Yeah, but then again, if the traffic circle's not working and the accidents goes up, then somebody's going to turn around and say, okay, this solution isn't working at this intersection, so let's try something else. You know, that's the free market.
Hey, Brian, I see you're in Wyoming. How's that Free State Wyoming thing working out?
I am not a member. I'm a big fan of Michael Dean, but, as you know, Wyoming is like the most sparsely populated. There's nobody in Wyoming. I mean, if you've ever driven through Wyoming,
I have.
You just drive and drive and drive and drive, and there's like nobody there. So,
but there's this movement.
I'm not a member of that. I would probably join the Free State Project and tried to talk my wife into considering. New
so
Hampshire.
You'd consider. So basically, what you're saying is living in Wyoming, and how long have you lived there?
On and off, I've traveled, lived in different places through the country, but for, 4 years and then 2 years.
So for several years, you've been living in Wyoming throughout the time in which the Free State Wyoming people have allegedly been there, and they have been so without impact that you are actually considering, if you're going to do anything, moving to New Hampshire.
Well, because New Hampshire is a smaller place where, as you guys always say, you can make more impact. Mm-hmm. I mean, Wyoming's definitely got, the close neighbor, I live in, northern Wyoming, and the close neighbor Montana, I mean, they definitely, the real groups are like, the militias, which you can kind of agree with, and, they do good things and they do bad things, but they definitely, that's where the organization really happens, in these kind of states up here.
So it's your understanding then that the people who've moved for the Free State Wyoming are really having no impact. You're not hearing any news about them. They're not getting elected. There's like nothing happening, right?
No, I would say, yeah, I'd say you're absolutely right. I mean, they are organizing, but it's kind of more like an Armageddon sort of thing, the communities do get together though. That is one thing that you really see up here is the communities get together, they organize,
What does that mean, though, when you say they organize?
Barbecues.
What's that?
Barbecues.
They're organizing barbecues.
that might be them, but the communities, do really organize up here.
I don't know what that means, though. When you say that they organize, what does that mean? Does it mean they do something, or are they
talking about doing something?
Well, it means organizing more on a community level, where you shop locally, you try to visit, instead of buying from Walmarts, which, those things don't really hardly exist around here.
Mm-hmm.
You buy from local farmers, local farmer markets and all that. And I know that exists in New Hampshire.
Yep. New Hampshire's the number three on the list of local, what they call local-vore states. Isn't it Vermont number one, Maine number two, and New Hampshire number three?
Yeah. This area of Arcadia.
Hey, thanks for the call tonight, Brian. I appreciate hearing from you. And of course, we're talking about the idea of the Free State Project. Free State Wyoming.
Also, crime is significantly lower in that particular three-state area, because communities created.
Free State Wyoming was a competitor to the Free State Project, and it's never really gone anywhere of any significance. And that's always what I hear. There was actually one guy who came to visit New Hampshire who lived in Wyoming for 7 years. He'd moved there for Free State Wyoming, and he left. After 7 years, not really, nothing's happening. But here in New Hampshire, there's more happening than you can possibly be involved with if you are a liberty activist. So check out freestateproject.org, and we'll continue with more Free Talk Live coming up.
Hi, this is Michael Dean from the Freedom Fiends Radio Show. The internet has lowered the cost barrier for a worldwide radio show to a price approaching zero. Yet there is one arena where you still need thousands of dollars to approach the audio quality of the corporate media. Doing a live spoken show with more than one host in different geographic locations. Our program, Fiend Phone, will solve that problem, and it will be given away free. Go to fiendphone.com to see what you can do to help. That's FEENPHONE.com.
In a far future universe, Earth's fleet is shattered, rife with guerrilla warfare, interspecies diplomacy, and full-scale interstellar combat. Humanity is about to face its trial by fire.
Trial by Fire, Book 2 in the Tales of the Terran Republic, sequel to the national best-selling and award-winning Fire with Fire, by distinguished professor and author Charles Gannon. Get it now from Amazon through shop.freetalklive.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and we'll take your calls about anything you want to discuss. Just dial in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Our website has all kinds of features, and we give them away. So go and enjoy those other talk show hosts in the business. They want to charge you $5, $6, $7, $8 a month, and we charge you zero. So go and get interactive over at freetalklive.com. Although there are ways that you can support the show, and we can tell you about those a little bit later.
Are you looking for an adventure? You know, you're not going to really know what life's about until you challenge yourself. The Survival Training School of California can provide you with that challenge. They've got classes for people of all levels of abilities, and you can go check them out at californiasurvivaltraining.com. The fact is, survival schools around the country, they're not regulated. They don't have a rating system. It really comes down to the instructors. And you don't want to mess with any of the imitators. CaliforniaSurvivalTraining.com is the place where, well, frankly, three branches of the U.S. military has trained. Here's a quote from J.J. Carroll Jr., commanding officer, United States Marine Corps Mountain Warfare Training Center. He said, they've earned the respect of the Marines. And Thomas Coyne there, he performed his duties steadfastly and is an asset to the training center. It's high praise coming. As a matter of fact, another one here from A.L. Mercier, commanding officer VX-31 U.S. Navy, says that strength and supremacy of today's Navy and Marine Corps stems in large measure from the outstanding quality of the training provided to our men and women. Your expert delivery of life-saving information will undoubtedly benefit VX-31. I mean, you don't get this kind of praise if you're a slipshod organization.
Mm-hmm.
Try it for yourself. California Survival Training.com. They've got some classes coming up, including a pocket knife only field training class. Should be awesome. CaliforniaSurvivalTraining.com. There's a telephone number for those that don't want to go to the internet. 805-503-8861. CaliforniaSurvivalTraining.com.
All right, so we'll take your calls about whatever's on your mind. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. It is the live Saturday edition. Uber and Lyft are under fire. They continue to be under attack by various different local governments around the country, even state governments going after these guys. And that's because they are a threat to the existing taxi monopoly out there, or the taxi oligopoly, I guess would be a more accurate term, a group of companies who have special permission to do business with one another. Well, cartel.
Cartel doesn't necessarily have to have permission. You're right.
It's close. Cartel's close. Let's go to Dana in Michigan. We'll get into the details on that. But Dana, were you in Grand Rapids tonight?
Yeah, I am.
And
yeah.
You're listening to WTKG. Go ahead.
Yes, sir, I am. Hey, you guys, can you explain? I thought I had this down, but I'm not really sure. And for those of us who aren't sure, and it's not that I'm lazy. I'm just so busy because it's summer in Michigan. But could you explain, and I'll take my, answer off the air, but could you explain the concept behind Uber, what it is, and why are people so up in arms about it? I'm catching snippets on things, something about the insurance and people's own private cars and things like that. Could you give us a rundown on that? Because I just heard while I was on hold that you are going to be addressing this. But could you pretend like some
this
of us...
This is a great way to force Free Talk Live to actually get to some of our show prep, because one of the biggest problems we have with this show is we'll tease a story as though we're going to talk about it and then go off on all kinds of different calls to whatever topics. So I'm glad you brought it up, and we will explain it. Thank you, Dana, for the call tonight.
Okay, thanks, guys. Have a good night.
Yeah, thank you. And apparently, Grand Rapids has Uber, so if you are in the Grand Rapids area, you can actually utilize this service. Unfortunately, here in Keene, we don't have that. We tried, though, Mark, when you and I were in Austin, Texas. We hadn't really planned very well for what we were going to do when we got off the plane. And we realized that, and we decided, oh, let's look at this Uber thing. We've been talking about it on the air. Lyft is their competitor. That's L-Y-F-T. But Uber and Lyft are kind of the two biggies out there.
And what they do is they provide an opportunity for regular folks with regular cars to share rides. And by that, what they mean is to make money through the internet, not being paid cash right on the spot, mm-hmm. although I guess you can give a tip if you want to, but they don't require it by
That's
any
right.
means. And that provides competition to the taxi oligopoly, as we talked about it. And that's really what the problem is.
Yeah, but there's more to it than what you've explained. There's also the technological aspect of it, right? Because it's because of the internet that Uber and Lyft are possible now.
Sure.
And so the way it's supposed to work, now I'm only going based on my understanding of this. I've never actually completed this transaction because when we tried in Austin, Uber's app told us, sorry, we're not available in Austin yet.
They certainly aren't in Keene.
But in Austin, it's due to the government. In Keene, it's just the market's too small. They just haven't come to this market yet. But due to the government of Austin and various other cities, and the story we've got, it's Salt Lake. But these governments are trying to stop Uber and Lyft, and they don't like the idea of them coming into town. But the idea of how it works is you get the app, you install the app on your smartphone device. And I guess you could do it with a computer too if you had like a laptop and a Wi-Fi access point. But anyway, it's usually the smartphone that you do this with. And so you load up their app. The app identifies your location using GPS, or you can punch it up on a map or something like that. And then basically you say, I need a ride to wherever it is you want to go. And ultimately there are people who drive for Uber and or Lyft who may happen to be in the area. So, for instance, we're at the airport. That's likely a place where Uber drivers are going to be hanging close to because they know there's business going to be there, just in the same way the taxi drivers hang around airports for the same reason. So you put in where you want to go, and the software hooks you up with a driver. You know, one of their drivers shows up, they pick you up, and then, you know, take you where you want to go, and they do it for a lot less, from what I understand, than the taxi cab companies do. And some of the reasons they can do it for less is because, well, number one, they're not paying for taxi cab medallions because Uber's not a taxi company. Essentially, Uber's a company. Uber doesn't own any cars. Uber doesn't have a dispatch. They don't have a physical, you know, office with somebody sitting on a two-way radio sending out cabs to a different place. They don't have any of that overhead. They have the overhead of running the software, so the programmers that they have to have their software and update it and add new markets and things like that. But ultimately, you know, the overhead's smaller. They're not paying for the taxi cab medallions, and in cities like New York City, those things can be $1 million, as I understand it, per cab, which dramatically increases the cost of doing business.
Dramatically. Well, one of the problems with Uber that we've seen up to this point is that people that, you know, drive for Uber won't get the kind of insurance you need to sort of do business. But I was in the pizza delivery business. I delivered pizzas at one point in the past. I didn't have the insurance to do that either, and that was an issue then. And I mean, we've managed in America to make it somehow or another without descending into a fiery abyss of chaos, without people necessarily having the proper insurance on their in every single situation.
How many of the Uber drivers are not insured properly?
How would we know?
Well, that's what I'm wondering.
How many pizza delivery people aren't?
Right. And how many times when you get into a car with somebody, are you checking their insurance? I mean, even if it's your friend or your, you know, your family members, how many times have you asked them, hey, are you current on your insurance payments?
She was specific about asking about insurance. I wanted to cover that.
Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We'll continue here. But my point is, how many times when you get a ride from one of your friends, do you ask them about their insurance coverage? Don't even think about that stuff, usually. More coming up here in moments. You can take control. We'll give you the latest on what's happening in Salt Lake, where they are hitting drivers hard with fines. What will happen there? We'll explain coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
Do you ever feel like you live in an alternate universe? As the stock market hits new highs, the middle class are dying. Manipulated financial markets and economic figures, chaos on our border, China and Russia bypassing the dollar. Life is getting ready to change. You need to prepare to thrive in the new economy. Go to babyboomerbackupplan.com or call 888-507-8789. That's 888-507-8789.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, Rich Paul is our first announced keynote speaker, and more are being announced now at keenvention.info. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. You can pre-order your tickets now for just $60 at keenvention.info, or you can pay with Bitcoin. Visit keenvention.info for more information and to lock in your tickets at the pre-order $60 price for the whole weekend. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Stop harming your body with coffee from grocery stores or most chains. Start making a difference, one cup at a time. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer you a free pound of BuzzBox coffee. It's organic, so no harmful pesticides or toxins. Shade grown, meaning less acidity and no heartburn. Try the best of the best for free. Just cover shipping. 10% of future purchases go toward helping us give the gift of human freedom around the globe with at least 100 microloans via World Vision. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
It was on this day in 1982 that the first roller skating while carrying a boombox member of Congress was elected when James Sugar Boots Franklin narrowly won New York's 8th congressional seat. Franklin's victory was a watershed moment at the time, signaling that America's burgeoning population of boombox carrying roller skaters had finally gained mainstream acceptance.
We prove Congress isn't just for suits and crew cuts. Say hello to the slickest legislator on 8 wheels. James Sugar Boots Franklin.
Franklin was an unlikely pioneer, a street-smart skater who admitted to being more concerned with impressing honeys with his silky smooth moves than with politics.
Franklin began organizing boombox-carrying roller skaters, advocating for basic rights like roller skate-accessible ramps in government buildings and protected street lanes where they could lay down cones for some sweet slaloming.
Just because we like to roll it out and have a smooth, fluid style that cannot be denied doesn't mean we aren't Americans. Yeah!
This is the Onion News Network.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, Saturday edition. We're here live, and you can take control of the airwaves. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I was using the Magic Mud last night, Mark. What is that?
My Magic Mud is a tooth-cleansing powder. And, you know, tooth powders actually, they've got a longer history than toothpastes. Hmm. But what's different about My Magic Mud is it was created by a homeschooling mother of three who loves the ideas of liberty and wanted to, create something to make the world better and sort of sustain her family. It's what she did is she took charcoal, like charcoal filters. Mm-hmm. And this is charcoalized, actually, coconut husks, which are the best among charcoal, apparently, and bentonite clay. And what it does is it bonds, just like charcoal filters do. They bond and take stuff out of the water. It bonds to the stuff in your mouth and pulls it right out. What I love about My Magic Mud, and the reason that I will use it forever and ever, even after they stop advertising here, is because my mouth feels cleaner than it ever did before. I wake up in the morning. You used to brush your teeth with, you know, fluoride toothpaste or whatever. You wake up in the morning, your teeth got that gunk on them. Not with My Magic Mud. They're clean for me in the morning time. Also, if you've got sort of gum sensitivities, My Magic Mud's great for that. People who don't like the taste of toothpaste at all, there's no taste for My Magic Mud. And it whitens teeth. Now, by whitens, what I mean is it removes stains. It will not change.
Not bleaching.
Yeah, it's not bleaching. It's not chemical or anything like that. It's all natural. You can swallow it. There's nothing wrong with it. I have. It's so sort of not bad for you that it's encouraged that you can swallow it. No big deal. It is messy. There's no doubt about it. The reason they call it My Magic Mud, you want to get down close to the drain when you brush your teeth.
I don't get down to the drain when I'm brushing my teeth. Only when I'm spitting out the, you know, the remnants.
Yeah, I try to get as close as I can. If you've got any questions, the first thing you should do is go to mymagicmud.com and see the interview with biological dentist Dr. Griffin Cole, where he explains many of the benefits of My Magic Mud. It's mymagicmud.com. It is awesome.
It's one of the coolest products we've had here, I think.
Happily endorse it. Yeah. I say you need to get this stuff. It is fantastic. Not very abrasive at all either. Mymagicmud.com.
All right, toll-free number 855-450-FREE. Are you an Uber driver or a driver for Lyft? These are the ride-sharing companies that have become very popular. In fact, I think it was actually John Bush, who is a friend of the show from Austin. We were talking about how the Austin government in Texas is preventing Uber from doing business. But John actually posted to his Facebook profile. He was so excited. He said, I used Uber for the first time tonight. Here's how it made me feel. F the taxi cartel. Market for the win, MF-er. Wait till the decentralized, peer-to-peer, blockchain-based alternative reaches the market. Monopolies, beware. There is no stopping the market in action. And what he's referencing there with the alternatives to Uber and Lyft, because Uber and Lyft are an alternative to the taxi oligopoly out there, this old, established, old kind of business that's been around forever.
And their cohort, their binary, the livery unions.
But there are programmers who are working with the blockchain technology, which is the technology behind Bitcoin. They're using the blockchain technology to create a decentralized system of being able to hail a rideshare, essentially. I don't know how to better explain how it works exactly, but it's
How would I know? I don't know how other people's businesses work, but it sounds...
Well, this one cuts out the middleman, so it won't even be a business, as I understand it. This will just be a way for people who have rides to offer to connect with people who have who need a ride. With so essentially, they would be cutting out the middleman of Lyft and Uber from this situation. So, you know, maybe Lyft and Uber's days are numbered at this point.
That is the marketplace. It's creative destruction. You know, the old businesses need to go away. You don't want to create protections for the candlestick makers at the cost of the light bulb manufacturer. You don't want to create protections for the farriers union that puts shoes on horses at the cost of the automobile manufacturers. You know, these things happen, and as the marketplace matures, they're going to happen more and more quickly. We all benefit. Every one of us benefit. Yes, there are no doubt somebody who was a blacksmith lost their job and had to go get some other form of employment because somebody was producing cars. There's no doubt about that. That happens. But old forms need to go away. New forms need to take their place.
Yeah, and you've got to be able to adjust to the market. And you, as the provider of those services, if the service you're providing is going out of style, you got to know when the right time is to leave. And, you know, even if you get forced out, you can't be all despondent about it. You know, crying about it's not going to bring back the farrier business, right?
Nope.
So, anyway, here's a story from Salt Lake Tribune. New high-tech ride-sharing services like Lyft and Uber say they're cheaper than a taxi, quicker, and friendlier. Salt Lake City, however, contends they are essentially unlicensed taxi services and is cracking down by issuing expensive tickets to drivers.
You know what I love about another thing I love about Uber and Lyft is that they allow the drivers to rate the passengers too.
That's true. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
that way a driver could see a bad passenger before they go and pick them up because the information's there. You can get it right out of the app.
I hated when I did drive cab, and I hated certain times of day and certain places that I would have to drive. I actually sort of, you know, said I'm just not going to do it, and so
drunks,
they put me. Yeah, I just wasn't interested in in that. Right, there's a lot of mess to clean up, and it's not comfortable. Either you feel like you're in danger from violence, or you've got to be hit on by a bunch of people you don't want to be hit on. No, I'm not going back to your apartment with you.
This is terrible what they're doing to these poor people. Angie Palmer, she's a college student and a driver for Lyft. She says, I received two tickets for $6,500 each.
Wow.
$13,000 in two tickets that she received because she gave somebody a ride. She gave a couple people a ride. Fellow Lyft driver Amanda Wardell, a single mom who drives for extra money, said it was pretty intense when she saw her own ticket for $6,500. She says, I haven't made that much driving for Lyft, so there aren't words to describe how it felt to see that. The city uses secret shopper tactics to ride on Lyft or Uber, then later sends a ticket by registered letter to the drivers. David ever. That way you don't know who the person was.
Sure,
who
that
was,
way they can use their undercovers over and over again.
David Everett. So they're not making the arrest right there on the spot like they might with a prostitution sting or something.
And
like
I'd like to point out that if in fact these Uber people were dangerous to society, then they're just letting them continue to operate. If it's worth arresting somebody and that's what a ticket is, then you need to handle it right away. They need to pull them over, put them in cuffs, throw them in jail. Either that or they're not a danger. Now, they obviously recognize these people aren't a danger, and all the city is doing at this point is acting like
It's just a protection racket. They're protecting the old businesses who've had their licenses for decades. You know, the old cabbie companies, whoever they are there in Salt Lake City.
They're not getting $6,500 tickets. They're paying their money up front in licensing fees.
They've been around for a long time. They know the people in the government. They've got sweetheart deals, and everything's groovy with them.
Can you imagine for a second if a city would just let people give rides to people without handing out tickets? My God, it'd be chaos. We'd descend into fiery anarchy. It's insane. We don't need these people.
No,
they're
really
crooks.
Don't.
The people handing out these tickets are leeches. They go home, they wear badges. We're supposed to respect them. They give them parades when they die. No, there's nothing respectable about this.
I don't even think this is the cops, Mark. I think this is a city issuing some sort of a... Maybe they do have some cop doing this, but it's certainly not a cop in the classic sense of they're putting them in handcuffs.
Well, these
they're
are the taxi them- cops.
Yeah, they're just sending them a letter. Of course, if you don't respond to the letter,
speeders don't get tickets. Don't get put in handcuffs.
That's
they
true.
Get tickets.
So, what happens if you don't respond to this $6,500 fine? What happens if you don't pay the fine? And by the way, remember when we were talking about some of the other news about Uber? Remember when the state of Virginia, was coming after them? Which, by the way, I believe they backed down since then. But Uber has been saying, and I don't know about Lyft, but Uber has been saying they're going to stand behind their drivers.
Right.
So I wonder if Lyft is doing the same thing, meaning that they would, if you get this fine, that they would provide you with legal assistance, essentially. That the drivers aren't going to have to go on their own on this. And so we'll find out more about this particular story. If you are an Uber or Lyft driver, especially in Salt Lake, we'd obviously love to hear from you or anywhere where similar crackdowns are happening. You can take control. Maybe you think these people are the Uber folks shouldn't be around. I want to hear from you if you're anti-Uber.
Wake up and smell the freedom. One of the easiest things you can do to help Liberty is to torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to help keep them drone-proof. You can set up your home computer to download and share Freedom Fiends archives over BitTorrent. You can even set up scheduling so it only shares while you're asleep or at work. Put your unused computing power to work and help keep the Freedom Fiends around well into the future. Simply go to freedomfiends.com and click on the Torrent Club link and learn how to torrent and share Freedom Fiends archives.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you, or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Hi, this is Steve Sanchez, and based on a recent study, it was found that 57 million Americans had legal issues over the last 12 months, but only 60% of those studied sought out the services of a lawyer. Why? In a nutshell, affordability. Well, my friends at LegalShield have created a solution that can help you not if, but when you need an attorney. For as little as $17 per month, LegalShield will provide you unlimited access to qualified attorneys at an accomplished law firm for advice and counsel on legal issues, no matter how serious or trivial. For over 40 years and with 1.4 million families across North America, LegalShield can help you, the loyal GCN listener. Representatives are standing by now to answer your questions, so call them now at 1-855-340-SAVE. That's 1-855-340-7283, or visit them at lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com.
Results will vary from case to case.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire.
The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Moments remain here. Enough time, though, for you, if you dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. We are probably one of the easiest national talk shows to get on because we really don't have much of a screening process. When you call Free Talk Live, want to get your name, where you're calling from, how you're listening, and in like maybe one or two words, what you want to talk about. Those other shows want to know all kinds of detail. They want to know exactly what you're going to say to the host when you get on the air, and if you change what you're saying to the host when you get on the air, they usually will cut you right off. We don't do that here on Free Talk Live. You can call in about anything you want here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live is brought to you by Keenvention. It's coming up. It's going to be here before you know it. It's about 3 months out at this point, October 31st through November 2nd. You've heard about Porkfest, the Porcupine Freedom Festival, the yearly camping event that happens here in New Hampshire that the Free State Project puts on. Maybe you've heard about the Liberty Forum, which is the other Free State Project event that happens in the wintertime where it's more of like a hotel kind of convention event. Well, Keenvention is your excuse to come visit New Hampshire in the fall. So the other events, spring and winter, or no, summer and winter. Keenvention is in the fall. In fact, it's a very nice time to come and visit New Hampshire. It's not too cold yet, usually, at that time of year, though you never really know. The real reason to come to Keenvention, though, is because you'll get to meet the activists. You'll get to meet the people who you hear about so much here on this show, and the focus of the discussions at Keenvention is activism, is, you know, the various different threads and types of activism that are happening here in New Hampshire. For those of you who listened to the show for a little while, you know that the Free State Project is a huge reason why New Hampshire is the destination for freedom, for people who care about liberty. And the Free State Project, they do great events. Please attend the Liberty Forum, attend the Porcupine Freedom Festival if you can. They're excellent events. But they focus more along the lines of, hey, let's bring in big name national speakers to attract a large audience so they can hear about the Free State Project ultimately. It's a good strategy, and it works for them.
It's just not that the strategy of Keenvention.
Right. It's just not at all what Keenvention does. At Keenvention, every speaker who goes on the stage is a New Hampshire-based liberty activist. So we've got panel discussions about the legislative process and being in the legislature running for office. We've got panels about civil disobedience and, you know, non-cooperation, Robin Hooding outreach, being in the media, being your own media. There's all kinds of different topics because there's so much activism that happens here in New Hampshire. It's not hard at all to, you know, pull up 50 different activists to come speak at Keenvention because we've got hundreds of people who've moved here. Over 1,600 people are here now in New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. So Keenvention is really a highlight for that. You can go to keenvention.info. You can grab your tickets now for just $60, or you can buy with Bitcoin over at keenvention.info. Again, October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 pre-event tickets are available. This is an intimate event. It's the size of an event where everybody's in the same room. There's no different tracks. You're either in the room or you're not in the room. If you're in the room, then there's, you know, dozens of people there, and you get to meet them all. It's easy to kind of get to know people in an event like that, which I think it brings a different flavor to the table. And
everybody
it's a lot
who
of fun.
Went seemed to be very happy with it.
I was really pleased.
I was so pleased that I actually donated money to make sure that you broke even.
You did, and you're going to host the media panel this year, aren't you?
Yeah, I need to start doing something about that.
Okay, yeah, you got to figure out your panelists, because it's like I don't even want to micromanage the panels. Basically, I pick invite different people to host a panel, and then it's up to you. You pick pick the panelists, you pick the topics. I don't want to tell you what to talk about. So come check it out. Go to keenvention.info. You can watch videos from last year, and you can really actually see the whole convention basically for free online at keenvention.info. Let's go and continue with your calls and thoughts. Uber drivers are under attack. Salt Lake this time issuing $6,500 tickets for people caught driving for Uber and Lyft. And Brian, you're on in Northern California on Free Talk Live. Hey, Brian.
Hey, thank you very much for taking the call.
Sure.
And a really great show. Very great, really good topics and very
Thanks.
Insightful dialogue. I just had a question. Years ago when I was a kid on the Central California coast in a little town just south of Hearst Castle, we had a situation where elderly people who couldn't get to their medical appointments and stuff, there was a group of seniors, usually in their 60s or whatever, they would volunteer to take these people to their medical appointments, take them to the store for groceries, etc.
That's sweet.
Should they have been fined $6,500 because they did that? Because they did it for nothing.
Well, in some cities, they probably would be if they even accepted a tip. Because there was a story out of Miami. This is one of the sort of iconic stories a few years ago that we talked about. This was actually, I think, before Uber and Lyft really even came into existence, where an older guy, probably in his 70s, picked up a young lady who was at a grocery store. She wanted a ride home. She's, looked like a single mom or something like that. She wanted to get a ride home. And he was willing to give her a ride home. And then at the end of the ride, she insisted that he take $5 from her.
For gas.
For the gas money and the time and all that. And he refused. He did not want to take the money. He was just doing this as a favor. I'm sorry, ma'am. Look, thank you, but no thank you. And she kept pushing it on him until he finally took it. Just to, look, all right, fine. I'll take it. Just get out of here.
Then she arrested him.
And then he was arrested. It wouldn't surprise me at all if they cracked down on those folks.
Because this was a community effort. Usually it was started by maybe the Rotary or the Lions Club or whatever, and said, look, we have this need in town, and we have retired people with cars, and they do have insurance and stuff like that.
So they weren't cracked down on, though. You were just kind of asking if some people would crack down on them. They weren't.
I mean, just tongue-in-cheek. I mean, it's kind of stupid to do this kind of stuff. And it's equally stupid to find people that have just, found a new niche, a new type of, like you said, between the livery stable and the automobile and stuff like that, and they're filling this niche, and why they should be penalized, I'm sorry, protecting the old oligarchy.
That's all it's about. It's not about protecting customers. It's about protecting the oligarchy. Thanks for the call, Brian. I appreciate hearing from you. A little bit more on the story here from Salt Lake City in the Tribune there, SLTrib.com. Everett, this is David Everett, the chief of staff to Mayor Ralph Becker, said the city had issued 118 citations to Lyft and Uber drivers.
That's a lot of money.
However, only 17 of them were warnings with no financial penalties.
Okay.
So they're threatening people with most of the citations, and then 17 of them are $6,500 extractions, demands for cash. Everett said the city had warned the firms that, quote, if you're someone making money, providing a ground transportation
transportation service, you need a ground transportation license. That's the way it's always been in the city.
We've always robbed people for tipping rides, and you will not stop us from robbing people. We make the roads. You pay for that in gas taxes? So what? You must give us more money because you're making money, and making money's evil.
He adds that enforcement keeps a level playing field between the new companies and the older taxi and shuttle services. Meanwhile, Lyft is fighting the tickets, contending it's different from a taxi service and is not covered by current taxi laws. Lyft is providing an attorney for their drivers, so that's good, because we knew Uber was doing that too, and says that it will pay any final fines for them as it has elsewhere nationally when other cities have similarly challenged the company.
It's got to take your breath away with that $6,500 ticket,
rough,
though.
Man. Well, it's a real indicator of who you're dealing with. You're dealing with a criminal gang who, there's no limits for these people. They don't care that you're a single mom trying to make a little bit of extra money on the weekends.
Yep, they throw you in, end up throwing you in debtor's prison for this, the equivalent, because, I mean, the government's the only organization that can throw you into a debtor's prison. They throw you into jail for this. People will just say, oh, you should have followed the law. I've been too scared to stand up for the government my whole life, so you should just follow the law.
Let's go to Joe. He's in Michigan listening to WTKG in Grand Rapids. Hey, Joe.
Yeah, this is straight up theft is what it is. And this, what do they care if somebody, you know, gives you a little bit of money to give you a ride someplace? They're just, it's just a protection racket, like you said. It's just,
well, they
like
care
the
because, hold on, Joe, they care because they want money, right? They want to get their cut. They hate it. These bureaucrats, these parasites, they hate it when business is being done and they don't get a cut. And there's no, you know, they're not getting a cut from whenever somebody buys an Uber or Lyft driver. None of that money is going to the city directly.
They're getting their fair share through gas taxes.
They're getting something through gas taxes.
It's the same as in the old days, they'd go after the bootleggers and stuff. They didn't care about people going blind, drinking liquor.
Sure.
It was all about tax money. And it's like the mob, man. It's like, you know, pay us money so protect your business. Meanwhile, they're the ones who really are vandalizing the businesses to scare people into paying them money not to do it.
It is not an inaccurate statement at all to liken the government to the mafia. That is essentially what they are.
The most successful organized crime institute in a given geographic area.
They've just done it more successfully.
They fly flags. They have a funny way of appointing dons.
And they, you know, they're so effective that they've managed to get people to pledge allegiance to them.
Yep. They'll say you're a bad person if you don't like them.
And worship their icons. Thank you for the call tonight. I wish we had more time for the folks that were on hold. Thanks. If you didn't get in tonight. Hey, we do it tomorrow. Mark will be here for the live Sunday edition. You can join him over at freetalklive.com at that time, or maybe on your local radio station as well. We'll see you online in the meantime at freetalklive.com. Have a great weekend.
America.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, lionsofliberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar. That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media or even in your typical social media newsfeed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at lionsofliberty.com, advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
Why does a U.S. orthodontist make more than some CEOs? You get that dental bill and you'll know. Implants, partial or full bridge, the kids need braces, fractions of U.S. prices. Balloon angioplasty for heart patients in the U.S. is $50,000. Thailand, under $7,000. Heart bypass, joint and hip replacement, cancer, many procedures under the price of your Obamacare deductible and copay. Don't risk bankruptcy. Hit us up now. We'll show you how at AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, August 9th, 2014. Silver is trading at $19.89 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,310 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $589. Antiwar.com reports, the end of the 72-hour Gaza ceasefire and the resumption of hostilities has not ended the ongoing Cairo peace talks, though Hamas spokesman Sami Zohri expressed serious concern about whether Israel was simply wasting our time. According to Hamas, the Israeli delegation rejected the vast majority of Palestinian demands, including all calls to ease the blockade of the Gaza Strip and to open a UN-managed seaport. Even the demands that weren't rejected were simply left unanswered, and Hamas believes that was evidence that Israel was dragging its feet to try to get the ceasefire to expire without a deal. European officials have offered to serve as observers for a seaport with a single route between Gaza and Cyprus, though so far it is unclear if Israel will allow this to happen. For years, Israel has responded to attempts to reach Gaza by sea with military force. In the spirit of Motorhome Diaries and Liberty on Tour, I intend to take the message of peace, love, and liberty on the road. During the 104-day trip, I'll be visiting at least 10 cities across the country, speaking to people about the ideas of peace, love, and liberty. To find out more about the tour or to donate, visit GoFundMe.com/FPPCC. That's GoFundMe.com/FPPCC. Reuters reports a former New Jersey Republican official who once worked with Governor Chris Christie was found dead along with her husband inside their home, according to officials on Friday, in what appeared to be a murder-suicide. Police discovered the bodies of Joan Bramall and her husband John inside their Denville home on Thursday, but the Morris County Prosecutor's Office declined to identify the bodies until Friday. An autopsy revealed that Joan Bramall was shot to death and her husband died of a self-inflicted gunshot wound, according to the prosecutor's office. The statement did not say that John shot his wife, though it did say that there was no evidence of any intruders in the home and added that the community was not at risk. The prosecutor's office could not be immediately reached to provide further detail or clarification, and it said in a statement it would not likely provide more information on Friday. Bramhall was the former Morris County clerk and stepped down in 2013 after her 14th consecutive year in the position. She had previously served as the chairwoman of the Morris County Republican Committee. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. The Washington Post reports American warplanes and drone strikes against militants in northern Iraq put the U.S. military back in action in the skies over Iraq less than 3 years after the troops were supposedly withdrawn by President Obama and he declared the war to be over. The strikes were limited in scope but helped temper days of building panic across the north of the country as militants with ISIS sliced through a string of towns and villages scattered on the outskirts of the Kurdish region and sent tens of thousands of civilians fleeing for their lives. The airstrikes also presented the first significant challenge yet to months of unchecked expansion by the Al-Qaeda offshoot, which has swept through much of Iraq and neighboring Syria over the past year, annihilating its opponents, capturing valuable resources, and declaring the creation of an Islamic caliphate in a nation-sized chunk of territory. In Washington, the Pentagon announced three separate strikes by multiple aircraft against militant positions it said were firing on Kurdish forces protecting Erbil. Kabul, saying they had successfully eliminated artillery, a mortar position, and a convoy of extremist fighters. Kurdish media and officials who said the attacks had a devastating impact on militant positions claimed other unconfirmed attacks that were farther afield. U.S. officials also stressed that the American intervention was narrowly aimed at the protection of American diplomats and officials living in Erbil, where the U.S. consulate has swelled with evacuees from the embassy in Baghdad, and where the U.S. military runs a joint operation center alongside Kurdish forces. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
With job numbers near historic lows, Forbes magazine has released a list of tips for finding a job, all of which involve witnessing an employer murder someone. Forbes says despite the grim economy, employers are still hungry for talented workers who